Benjamin Green.
You are going to go to sleep now.
Yes.
Place down your copybooks now.
Stop fighting now. I should probably buy healing items before I forget to.
You've got a mushroom on your shirt.
Oh, I'm a failure.
I'm a loser.
What's happening?
Well, that's a quote from Arthur out of context.
Yes.
Like the kids show?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I love it.
Yeah, Francine has a mushroom on her shirt, and like her grandma or somebody points it out, and she just goes, "Oh, I'm a failure." There was context, but it's funnier without. Yeah, I've got a decent amount of items, I think, but it's like I've got fucking 3 million cash monies.
Is this the Elite Four of this game?
It will be probably before long. I'm just gonna hide behind this wall.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So I guess
all normal things.
Yes. So, okay. Actually, hold on. Let's see what shit I can pick up. No, I'm not gonna even do that. I will actually do that. I'll just go in with this team of like legendary things that I'll be got 9 mystery gifts. Sure. What is it? Whatever. Fuck it. He's got like freaking Arceus and Lugia and like all this random shit. Good. It'll probably be the Alola Elite Four and nothing else. So I haven't touched this game in years, other than last night when I booted it up just to, like, see where I was saved. Here's a shiny Lombre, and here's a shiny Yanmega. Those exist. I can say that much with relative certainty.
Relative ease.
So we're gonna have to start off the same way that we did last time with deciding what team I'm using here. Because I've got 12 to pick
from. You gotta use all of them.
Yeah, I mean, that one's just non-negotiable. I figure we will use Koblaron because it is shiny, and I want to use the Zygarde. Kuke, maybe. Kuke does suck, but I like
it. I love it!
I love Kuke.
We have to use him!
I agree.
Alright, we're going for- God, this- I might regret this choice, but we'll try it, so. We've got 2 choices in which to try to get some type coverage in here. I do like Gaster. Gaster is cool. I don't have a ghost or a fire, ooh, so we could probably stand to do that. Although...
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, let's do that. Alright, so we actually only have 1 choice. Choice! Let's see. We've already got a rock. We've got a dragon. I'm thinking maybe Binyat. I don't know. Let's look at.
I have always sets. Wanted to use a Xion'Nod, but I don't remember what it's called.
Obviously, Bruxtorena, the freaking bluefish. Gunk Iller is still one of my
Beatrice.
Favorite nicknames.
You almost dropped that thing, didn't you?
Yeah, I was gonna. I forget what I was planning to replace it with, but I ended up just not doing it. Let's see. Freaking Cold Steel the Hedgehog. Well, let's see. I've got. I think these are all physical attackers, aren't they? Well, this one's not an attacker at all. Yeah, let's go for a special. So I think that's probably going to be Binyat. Let's see. Do I have other?
Or it could be,
Fortran, Beatrice. Okay, yeah. I'll pick whatever is... I've got a Grass Fairy and a Bug Fairy, I guess, are the main choices. I don't want to double up on Dragon types.
Or normal types.
I don't usually think of normal flying as being normal type, but I guess technically, yeah. Any opinions?
Is that from us?
Yeah.
I'll let Nicole take this one.
Especially attacking Golem. Let's go.
Mushroom.
Mushroom Kingdom. Okay. Permanent guest.
I'm so excited for Pukumuku.
Was it like the first, third, fourth, seventh, and ninth hotels were no problem, but...
I don't remember. Listen up, Haley. Here's where I give. Any point? Well, I mean, I have Gunk Iller as a poison type. Are you talking about, like, Elite Four? Well, let's see. What does Elite Four have? There is, I think, fighting, flying...
Nope.
No?
There's no fighting in this Elite Four.
Oh. I guess I don't remember it. It's like, three of the kahunas plus random bird golfing girl, right?
That was the original.
Oh, they changed it? Okay. In that case, don't tell me, because I don't know. Let's immediately put things off by just going into Ultra Space and dicking around for, like, 20 minutes.
And before somebody in chat spoils it.
Yeah, probably.
Now, granted, I might be getting
I forgot this game didn't have a bike. God, I haven't touched this game in fucking ages.
Today is beating the Elite Four, like the other streams.
Yeah, pretty much.
This is the finishing Pokemon Games That Josh Abandoned series. It's me.
Nobody involved knows of the... That's it, just the...
That might be something else.
Actually, hold on, can I fly directly to the place?
Yeah.
It's here, right?
On this island.
It's not?
It's on Ulula. I was wondering where you were going.
Well, I was gonna go to the place with the frickin' wormholes.
Oh, really? Oh, yeah, you can go there. It's a top one.
Okay. I just figured I'd do, like, one or two of those just to mess around with it. I gave up on living decks for this game. I fucking hate the SOS system so much. Like, it was never gonna be a full living decks anyway. It was just gonna be whatever stuff you could get within the game without importing. But, yeah, I kinda stopped caring about that, too. I bet your mom misses you, too. Let's see how this thing works. I don't even remember the mechanics. I think it's just collect orb and avoid hole until you get far. I think there's still some UBs I haven't caught. There's definitely legendaries I haven't caught. I'm not gonna try to do it on stream. Oh, right, you avoid those. Also, I like how... by default, isn't this usually motion control? And you have to, like, go to an obscure setting somewhere to change it?
It's not an obscure setting. You have to go to Game Freak's office in-game.
Oh my god. What the fuck? Why? What is it with Game Freak just not making things convenient? It's like, oh yeah, we'll have an audio setting in Sword and Shield, but, you know, we'll just tie it behind this random fucking
item.
NPC.
Yeah.
This is the Sonic 2 bonus stage, yeah, kinda.
Except Sonic 2 bonus stage kinda sucks and people actually like this, right?
I thought people hated this, I don't know.
Oh, I don't have the impression that people really liked it.
It's interesting, I don't know if I want to do it 500 times to find shinies and... I'm wondering how many legendaries I'm- ooh, here's a double ring. Is this a UB or is this a legendary? What is this? Doesn't look like a UB. It might not be a legendary either. It's probably just like, hey look, you found a Pelipper. What is that, a Skarmory? Oh. It's Carl. Okay. Can't say I'm terribly impressed by this.
Yeah, shiny rate. Isn't the shiny rate like 1 in 56 here or something?
It's something high like that. Yeah, whatever. Oh, I was unable to run. Maybe because it's 12 levels higher than me. I didn't realize I was such a low level. Is that going to be a major issue again, except this time I don't have experience candies to make up the difference?
One, I can check on Bulbapedia, and two, Nicole's been real quiet. You still there?
Hmm.
Uh-oh. Apparently I was muted.
Oops.
Did you realize that you were muted? Were you talking?
I realized you asked when I was quiet.
Oh, shit.
Well.
It's okay, I had nothing of importance to say.
Alright.
Let's see. Elite Four levels seem to be 56, 57.
Hmm.
You'll probably be fine.
Yeah, hopefully.
Man, what the fuck are you talking about? I'm on Bulbapedia, and it's auto-playing a video, not with audio, but it says, Pokemon fan theory claims trainer battles are actually attempted robberies. Like, okay.
Oh my
what?
God, I think I've seen
oh, hey, it's GLaDOS, or whatever I call this guy.
Oh, Gladion!
Fucking edgelord.
There are quite a few fan theories about the series. Some of them make aspects of the game seem more sinister. One theory that is becoming popular on the internet is about the trainer battles in the game. Is it that they're attempted robberies? According to a theory by Reddit user The Mighty Tho, when NPC
the Mighty Tho
player, they are actually attempting to rob them! Exclamation point. Why is this on Bulbapedia? Why is it also playing a fucking video about some Reddit asshole's theory?
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh, I have animations turned off. I'll probably change that after this. Oh, good. Alright, I forgot. Stone Miss.
Wait, why the fuck are you in, like, a canyon? I thought you were on the base of a snowy mountain.
Oh, you know. I don't
actually. It's not as bad as Sword and Shield's, like, you go fishing in a city and then you show
you're
up
just
in
suddenly in
a
field, yeah.
I have, like, a dark chocolate bar here, and it's not telling me what percent of dark chocolate it is.
Well, it's a dark chocolate bar, so 100.
What? No. Oh,
wholesome Keanu Chungus 100.
Excuse
I doubt
me.
It.
Oh, I like how much damage Stone Edge did. Or Stealth
Probably
rocks.
Probably, like, 70. It looks like
hello, peoples.
Brown people.
I remember when I was a viewer.
What the hell was that?
And I sent in a Pokemon, and I was... And that made me happy.
I'm not happy.
What the fuck?
Swirling my rabbit bone in my cup.
I could!
Why, when I was my own age. Hey, congratulations, Kif. I'm almost done with school stuff. I have exams between May 10th and May 19th, and in the middle of those I have a deadline, which means I should probably get that done before the exams. Other than that, that's it. I think it's like 6 exams total.
Is this water?
It depends on what stuff
I know. Oh, it's based on the starter. Okay.
Yeah.
I actually don't know what starter I picked. It might have been Litten, so I guess that's
I mean, this that's certainly not grass or fire, yeah, fucking Silvally. Silvally. Right. There is no fighting ground type.
Hmm.
It's true. There's only a few unused combinations left, probably like 20 if I had to guess, but don't get through them. I mean, that is the totem whack, yes. Not to be confused with a Google whack.
Google Amapu
Pin. Not to be confused with Google Fights. Which is not to be confused with Google Mapu Pin, yes.
Mega
Ultra Chicken. What's that from?
Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
Well,
I'm not a fan of where this is already going. Here, you, I guess, even though you're neutral to water.
What is that name?
What, Fergico Sink? it's one of the strange creatures from Barger the Big Dip. It's Zyger Bly Fergie Kosank, and this thing is Zygarde, so.
Yeah, it's Rocker Steinberg, Sinfield, Zyger Bly Fergie Kosank, and Jofrankiolunkarat?
Yeah. I'm unsure of how to deal with this thing.
You super effective hit.
Yeah, Bullet Seed. Actually, I think with Skill Link, Bullet Seed's not bad.
That's why you have it. Oh, boy! Aw, oh, come on.
Unfortunately.
I could potentially finish it off with
Extreme
with Extreme Speed from Zygarde.
An extreme president.
Oh, Zygarde. Zygarde dead. Never mind.
He fucking dead.
Thank you forever.
I'm
not liking my chances against the Elite Four if I can't even beat this.
One time I wrote BillyWitchDoctor.com feel more comfortable with chicken in chat, and BillyWitchDoctor.com turned into a link, and then Cheese clicked on it and was like, Autumn, that thing tried to give me a virus, and I'm like, oh, it was an Aqua Teen Hunger Force reference. He was like, oh, I know, but I tried to click it anyway, and it almost gave me a virus. I'm like, okay, how was that my fault?
What the fuck?
Also, extreme speed was not enough. That was good. Cuke, go. You can do it.
Yay,
I mean, Toxic would kill it. I'll just use counter, as it's been using physical moves, I think.
WWYZZERDD.
.com.
Oh, we need to add him to Tomodachi.
Oh, the internet wizard?
Yes.
Oh, good, Memento. No, fuck, I don't want Memento.
Well, I mean, that's why he's using it in 10%, because the legendary versions would be too good. 50% is probably good.
Yeah, I... Can I actually change it in this game, or do I have to, like, send it to a different game and change it?
Change what?
Zygarde's form.
Oh, the form? I don't know. I think you have to send it to the original sentiment, but I'm not sure.
I could potentially do that. I kind of want Dream Eater, but I don't want to get rid of Strength Sap or either of the stab moves.
No, I don't think you should add Dream Eater.
Piddle the dodge.
Dream Eater is just...
Why is everything learning moves? What the hell?
Like, Dream Eater is just worse Strength Sap in your case. Like, you can put them to sleep, obviously, but... It's just an extra step, and it doesn't lower their attack.
Slavery with extra steps.
Slavery with attitude.
His hand is like mine, like an hour ago.
Were you writing too much?
I was very shaky. I was doing a presentation. It was nerves.
I can imagine.
Oh.
Fuck's sake.
Okay.
Wow, this is shit.
Yeah. Cuke saved the day.
Cuke is my favorite
this
team.
This thing probably has a steel move.
Yeah.
But it might not.
Nah, you're right, it probably will.
Revive, maybe. I think his last Pokemon's Paragon Z. So maybe Gastrodon. I don't know, I can check. I know he has that in at least one of his battles.
Yeah, I'll just...
Gladion.
Oh, Hyper Voice, okay. And Power of Love. I'll accept this.
No, his last one is Zoroark. Wait, unless you already took out the Zoroark.
I did not.
Okay.
This is, like, awful, because you're fucking Mushroom. Just survived an attack for- Oh, I thought you were gonna heal something else. Never mind, you're good, you're clean, you're pure.
There we go, okay.
Bruh.
Alright, do I have any- It is weak to ground, yeah, I can- Alright. Get some burn hacks going. That is a possibility.
Singing about pies.
I kind of want to get up a dragon dance, but...
This is Zoroark? Oh, it did use Night Days, you're right. How did you damage it?
Oh, it was only with Stealth Rock, that's stupid.
Ah, okay. This
okay.
Is
all,
yeah.
well, whatever, I'll go for the stab move anyway. See, Lucario has such a big fucking moveset, I didn't... think anything
yeah.
of that.
Yeah,
is Night Days a Zoroark exclusive?
I think it might be.
Okay.
It's the Tell.
Shit.
Jesus. If Banyan wasn't at 2 HP, I would recommend going in and using Moonblast, but...
Yeah. Well, whatever, I'll just Hyper Potion. Okay, so I've got to think of... I hope there's, like... some way that I can somehow gain a bunch of levels. I don't know what that way would be. I do have some rare candies. I don't have a ton of them, but I mean... I could use those, I guess.
Try to get as far as you can without them first. Like, get up to just before the Elite Four, I would say. actually, Night Daze is not exclusive to Zoroark. Lunala can learn it as well, according to Bulbapedia.
Okay. This one I can at least finish off with Kyuk, so that'll be fine.
Kyuk.
I will hope that it misses and use four. Oh, shit.
Oh, damn. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, that was bad.
Fuck you, Gladion.
I've got revives.
I've got revives.
Thank you, Hunter.
I've got revives!
I do have a soft spot for the emo bastards of life. Like, I had a sweater, like, basically exactly like his as a kid. It was black with, like, red rips through it. Like, fuck.
Terrible. Oh yeah, I forgot your character in this game is just constantly staring into the void and grinning.
That's at least one thing they slightly improved on in Gen 8.
Yeah.
I bet you're Gladion to be done with that.
If you two are gonna get even stronger, I guess I can't let my guard down yet.
He smiled!
Oh, I think we should be enemies. Yeah, can't fit, yeah. Okay, so all of the, like, Poke Pelago stuff is, like, passive leveling, right? It's, you can't just go there and be like, oh, hey, here, get a bunch of experience.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, it takes, like, about a day for them to complete the thing.
Okay. That's fine.
I think you can choose a day or half a day.
Huh? Autumn, what were you saying?
Oh, just I played through an Alola game 4 times and I've never bothered with Poke Pelago.
Also, yeah, turning experience share on. I kept that thing off because I just genuinely hate it, but I will take it now. It will save me time. How many events do I have stacked there? Quite a few.
I can't remember. Ultra is the one with the Shybros on Dex, right?
I don't know.
Because in the original game, he's like a cocky bastard. And then I think in Ultra Sun, they made him like shy.
I remember Joel saying that it has the personality of a piece of paper.
I thought it was cute.
Same.
Now I can't think of it without being reminded of the edit someone made of him saying, like, would you like to bond with me, Mazder? And then, like, the responses are like, we shouldn't be doing this.
Terrible.
If anyone has that image,
oh no, it is Anna Trainer.
I like the dramatic, like, black. I like the black that's, like, super dramatic with the trainer.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so hold on. Do I have the... It would be in key items, right? The Zygarde cube thing? Or
probably.
Potentially I go to a place. Anyone want to check that? Because I might go up to 50% form. I feel weird using, like, a full-on legendary, but, I mean, fuck it.
You already were.
Well, I mean, the 10% form is like, you know, it's kind of a weak one. Also, I have to change this image periodically. I don't know, it's just a random picture of all the Gen 7 stuff, so... I mean, it's an image of every Pokemon, but I'm just focusing
on... Well, actually, it's a la-ha. Less.
Not getting Cube until post-game? Okay, so... That would be trade to Moon, use Cube, trade back. Which is a little annoying, but I mean, I can deal with it. No, I mean, I might still do it.
Josh, did you?
No, I don't think I did. Shit.
Oh my god.
Moon.
But why?
I don't know.
Was it relevant to anything?
Well, Moon.
Oh.
That was an error.
Okay. Psychic Dark. What are... I don't have any bug moves. Fuck it, I'll just stay in. Yeah, let's use a Z move. I haven't used one of these in a while.
Smooth. Trivia question. What does the Z and Z move stand for?
Zenith?
Correct.
Okay, new question. Why?
Because it's a letter, so it needs to stand for something.
Also, reminder that Game Freak felt the need to program in something into the game that would have the DS output some kind of signal that could be picked up by a fucking plastic toy. So that, like, yeah, if you have, like, the toy Z-ring, it'll, like, flash when you use a move in the game.
I love it.
The Zeitgeist would have been a more fitting name for it.
What was that at the end?
Because it's a joke at Game Freak's expense, because they keep doing, like, flavor of the game gimmicks.
I don't actually know what Zeitgeist means.
It's like something that's popular at the moment, basically.
Ah. Okay, then yeah, I guess that works.
Like a trend or something.
Alright, so here's what we gotta do. Dog? No. Dog, and then...
And now you can block the way for anybody trying to progress through Victory Road because you're looking for items.
Ugh, God.
You know, Victory Road.
This is basically Victory Road.
It's just kind of a shitty one. I think the Ancient Pony Canyon or whatever it's called is kind of more of a proper one.
Oh, Absol. I love Absol.
Yeah, it's like a legend.
Absol's cool.
You said that exactly the same time. Exactly the same way.
I love how fucking pissed off Toucanon is.
Yeah.
Why do people hate this thing again?
Anger.
They do?
I mean, I remember when Sun and Moon first came out, they're like, this Pokemon is literally just a fucking Toucan, and they didn't even change it.
It's Toucan Sam.
I mean, I guess there you go. They think it looks too similar to a normal Toucan. Literally just my mom's Toucan.
Yeah, I think it's because it, like, it becomes, like, evolves from a fucking woodpecker.
Maybe.
I like Pick-a-Peck.
Yeah. And Sun. Sun and Moon, this area is just two rooms. I don't remember.
Oh,
that.
Did they make it bigger? I remember it being very dinky.
I don't have any memory of that. I don't believe you. I can see people maybe being like, oh, Talonflame was cool because it stopped being normal flying, and then they just went back to doing the normal flying again, so it's lame. I can see that, but also I don't think they should
have to do that. Spelled weird versus Haley spelled weird.
Sorry.
Also, Shinnok's cry is amazing. It's just.
Oh my god. I was not expecting that.
You're a fairy. I should maybe switch out.
Booter Bubs.
Onion Bubs! Yeah!
Onion Bubs is pretty good.
What if Onion San was Asian?
What if Papyrus? Oh no.
A truly embellished cry would be like... I can't do it.
What, the gnome fart?
Yes! Yeah, it's like... I can't.
I might have a few chesto berries.
Maybe.
Goodness.
Requires further investigation. Also, I like how in Gen 8 there is no normal flying type Pokemon introduced.
Good.
Must take every opportunity to be an asshole and make fun of people's spelling.
Yes. Wasn't Morkella the name of Martin's Paris from the Silver, like the Soul Silver solo run? I ask as if you would totally remember this.
To be fair, I named a Pachirisu after your Plusle, and for no other reason.
I too use the berry growing to grow like a million Leppa berries and then never use them.
Better that than farming for fucking 800 beast balls like I did.
Still, can you just buy them in this game?
In this game you can, yeah. In the first one you couldn't, and I made it a point to go through great lengths to acquire a bunch of them, because I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna totally do like a full living dex where everything's beast balls.
I thought the way you did them was by not having enough during that quest, and so the only way to do it while keeping them was to like put them on Pokemon and then trade them away. No?
You put them on Pokemon and then put them in the PC. I did this until every single thing in my PC was holding a beast ball. It was so fucking bad. It took like over a week. There was no reason for me to do this.
Well,
Brendan, look what
run out of them.
Look what I did to the card catalog. Tore everything out and threw it all over. Nobody will ever be able to use this again.
Nobody will ever
That's
know.
That's like my nightmare, though.
Brendan, we gotta get out of here. Get on my back and let's go.
Me walking up to my foster brother and on top of a giant duck thing and being like, you have to get on. There's no time to explain.
Oh boy, false swipe. Finish it off with force swipe.
Finish him. Then maybe you can teach it fury swipes.
I like fury swipes.
Me too.
Enough out of you.
Okay. Listen up, Ailey. Here's what...
Did you know that the QR scanner can scan QR codes?
Press the X
button.
Shocking revelation. Alonza. Also, why do these people in fucking Victory Road only have two Pokemon?
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay.
That I can't hear the game.
Is sound balance okay? I can turn up game a little bit. I just don't want it to drown anything out.
Oh, well, I just mean I can't hear it at all because it's screen share. It's not coming.
Yeah,
yes,
I can't hear it either.
Oh, I didn't realize that was a thing. Okay.
Well, yeah.
I guess that makes sense, yeah. Actually, hold on. Instead of me sharing, instead of me screen sharing that, let me actually share the 3DS capture. That would probably make more sense.
Oh.
Not that you really need the sound, but you know, still, it'll be less intensive anyway.
Yeah.
There. Is that giving you noise?
Oh, yeah.
Noise.
Yeah.
Not
yeah,
sound.
Cool.
Noise.
I can hear it.
Sound like my mom. That's not even music, it's just noise.
For some reason, my mom really hates video game music. Like, it's not even just like 8-bit or chiptune stuff. Like, anything that's like from a video game, she tends to hate it.
Yeah,
which is weird, because
like
it's
mom.
Not... It's not that different from just like, you know...
I guess most people most people don't usually listen to instrumental music, so if you don't like that, then you're
My mom occasionally listens to like classic or instrumental jazz.
Does she like jazz?
No B movies.
Only B movies. In fact, I will now switch out my team, get Beatrice on there, and rename it to B movie. Huh.
You shouldn't do that.
I'm loving this amount of potions I'm using.
You know, from nature.
I like how you quote it as "you know from nature," and thus everyone thinks it's "you know from nature." But I checked, and it's "like from nature."
Oh.
Yeah, I also noticed that, but I just kept the the OG.
I probably wouldn't have noticed that, except for when I was naming one of the banjo segments, in which I was the B. I was gonna name it that, and I'm like, let me just like look up the quote to get it exact, and it was "like from nature." I have uncovered a conspiracy!
Yes. this is probably gonna go poorly. I like how I don't have any dragon moves.
I should tell that Persona 5 invented jazz. It is really stupid whenever a song is even slightly jazzy or funky, and people are like, this sounds like Persona music. Like,
does it hit different?
Oh my god, I fucking hate that. I love that phrase. I hate it hits different, I hate it slaps, I hate it's a bop.
It slaps is awful. I am guilty of saying it's a bop, though.
I do remember you saying
that
it's a bop.
That was not as bad. It's still kind of, I don't know, I just get annoyed by pretty much all the slang used by people, like, around my age. I don't
The bop
like
one is one that I started using ironically and now cannot stop.
Oh, that was...
Yeah, that's the common problem.
Well, if I wasn't going back to heal before that, I definitely am now.
This song bangs. This song fucks. I have actually heard people say, like, it fucks to describe something as good.
This beat's so sick, it's fucked.
Yeah, there you go, fucking Gibson.
I don't think I've ever heard that.
I'm not a fan of that one.
Face.
It's so fucking suck it fucks. Oh, I like this song a lot, actually. I forgot it.
You actually don't.
Well,
you're gaslighting me.
Yeah.
Ooh, poison jab.
I probably don't have anything that can learn that, but let's see.
You probably do.
No. Dagger and claw.
Everyone fought. Fist.
Candy fist, fist is all that I eat. Nobody can stop the Robotashi fist. F F F F F F F F F.
No.
Okay. This is where I give you advice you didn't ask for. Yes, thank you.
But yeah, just buy healing items, dude.
I
have enough.
I know. I'll buy some more.
But yeah, I was actually going to use the Maulana Keela music in my Zelda Classic quest, which I haven't worked on in a bit. I made almost a whole world in the original, like, it was an NES style. And then I'm like, I kind of want to see what this would look like with the better tile set. So I switched to DOR. And then I started making it. I'm like, okay, this is too good. I can't not use this now. So then I remade the entire map. And then... Except I'm not quite caught up, because, like, some of the sub-areas don't have maps yet, because I don't have the right tiles. And, like, we had some ideas for that, and then I also would have to script a boss fight, which I was going to ask Rob for help for, and then I put that off, because I had a bunch of other projects I was doing. And basically, I never end up finishing anything, because I just move on to another project for a while.
Yeah, sounds like that.
Sucks. But yeah, I was going to use the Maulana Keela music for the... fifth world, which is gonna be like a snowy mountain.
Gotta use the QR scanner so we can look at my keyboard. Yeah, keyboard. Yeah.
Inland.
Yeah.
I love it.
Oh shit!
Oh my god!
And if you look to the side, they're always watching.
I love it.
You have to use something from that for the thumbnail. If possible.
No.
Well, I know it's possible, but... I don't know. You should bother.
Should have shown off the beard? No. I don't have a face. I don't have a face that looks good, at least. I like the pile of Pikachus and Eevees at the top.
What?
The image that I just scrolled a bit more.
Oh, I can't see it.
Right.
I can see it in the stream.
Oh yeah, why do you have a folder of Josh's face? Even I don't have that.
Yeah, it's a little concerning.
Well, I have the Magabond face, and
how about the one with the hoodoo and the pancakes?
The hoodoo and the pancake, and just any other ones like you send me.
Okay, well, somebody mentioned Strong Bad. I gotta go get the doll now.
Oh, good.
Check me out! Oh,
check me out! I love him.
It'll just randomly interject.
Okay, what is this image?
It's probably bad.
When is this even from?
Okay, now I've got to look. I don't like this.
I remember that one.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. Yeah, I took that picture at work. I think I just sent that to Nicole one day when I was bored.
How the fuck did it get in your hands, then, Red Star?
I probably posted it on the Discord at some point.
Probably.
Solidly.
I fucking hate the way this Machamp carries you.
It's so concerning. I don't know.
Someone in the dev team definitely had a fetish. There's no fucking doubt in my mind. I mean, obviously, yeah, because Sarina also exists. And,
Salazzle.
Salazzle, yeah. I'm trying to think of any other obvious ones, because there's waifu ones, and then there's this was obviously a developer's fetish mon. You could argue with God of War or Lopunny. I feel like those were just designs that were made feminine.
I fucking hate Lopunny so much.
I don't feel like Lopunny was made with the intent to be oh yeah, this one's gonna fucking get their rocks off.
Yikes.
It's weird because Gardevoir is probably one of my favorites. I don't know if it's in my top 10, but it's up there. But I fucking hate Lopunny. I hate Salazzle. Sarina is I would call it slightly below average, but I don't hate it.
Sarina is inoffensive enough. Salazzle is just what the fuck were they thinking?
Lizard tit discourse. Tit course, okay.
Cat tit bingo.
Big dick in his little brother's bum. Cat. Which word was supposed to be cat? Also, what do you mean it could be a Hypno instead? What could be a Hypno instead? It is one of the Pokemon I dislike out of two. But.
Piddle the Darth. Piddle the Darth.
I always brought up. Tags ugly pat. No.
For what? The picture of me?
That's mean. I hope they didn't mean that. They're probably referring to something else. Shush! None of that. I mean, I have Josh memes too. I have that image where I edited the 2005.
Oh god, the fucking anime
to have
girl thing in it. Yeah.
In it. Yeah.
I fucking hate that image. I didn't even realize that was you until, like, I think I randomly mentioned it one day, and you're like, oh yeah, that was me. Like, what? Why?
Because I had an idea, and I couldn't just not let it exist.
I love it.
Mindless driving, what?
Yeah, I've seen you post this one, and I've never found it funny. It's incredibly forced.
What is it?
It's... I don't even know how to describe... I've seen this meme before. I don't know what it's from. I want to say, all like... Right.
I have also seen this.
Hold on, let me look.
It is very forced.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that was kind of bad. Yeah, Max Reviv. Repives.
Oh my god. Okay.
Did you see the tweet from a couple weeks ago where they were like, did you get hey trainers? You already know what I'm gonna say?
No.
They're like, hey trainers, did you know that Arbok spelled backwards is Cobra? And then people like,
I wonder if people brought up Muck.
People are like, what the fuck were you expecting?
Hey trainers, which of these Pokemon evolves into Seviper?
That's right, it's Arbok.
One of the options being Suicune. I will attempt to catch this.
Lilligant and Lurantis aren't even really sexualized, though. Serena, kind of.
Lilligant, like, I mean, I wouldn't call it sexualized, but it's like... Yeah.
Lilligant is just a plant lady. There's nothing, like... You know?
Yeah, I like
it's
Lilligant.
It's not, like, provocative. And neither is Lurantis. Lurantis has trousers. That does not make it provocative.
It has bacon legs.
It has pinstriped trousers.
Pinstripe hourglass.
Striped pants.
Striped pants. Calling for help.
Why are you even fighting this?
I don't have one yet. I figured I'd just catch it for the hell of it.
Okay. Lurantis has it does!
Plus, I do need to level up, so anything that I KO is helpful.
I like the description. Bacon legs.
Yes, I used Lurantis on my first Sun team. I named it Lulu.
I find Lurantis and Sarina, like, oddly repetitive. Because I think they have pretty similar stats. And they're both
they
just
pure
grass.
Pure grass and physical attackers, yeah. It's kind of a shame.
I have a Lilligant on my white team, I think.
Never used Lilligant. I used Whimsicott, though. Whimsicott's one of my favorite Pokemon ever. Might be my favorite Gen 5.
Hmm.
Oh, no, BM. Yeah. Probably my second favorite Gen 5, then. I also like Toucan.
I'm trying to remember what you had on your team in white, because not counting Hadoo, because that one was temporary. You have Snowcone.
I have Monster was... Kid, the like Scrafty.
Yes. I think you had a Chandelure.
Rook the Sharp.
Because you named the Chandelure the same as mine, right, Calcifer?
Yeah.
Hyper Voice. That's actually not bad. Well, Physical Attacker. Well, 100 Special.
If that's not evidence, I'm pretty sure people have probably said that about every Pokemon. And I maintain that Sarina, there's a difference between Sarina's obvious, like, dominatrix design influence and Lurantis just being a pretty normal humanoid-ish grass type. Like, even that it's a bug that is just...
Yeah. It is slightly humanoid. That's about it.
Yeah. What was it you also couldn't do on GameFAQs? I mean, you couldn't mention gay, but
there was something. It was Bottles Boggy, spelled out Lesbo. It's like how in the fucking Tomodachi Life song that Vinny did, the back of a giant sea turtle, of a giant, spelled out fag.
Oh.
So seriously, what the hell is Glalie supposed to be?
Hockey Mask, right?
Sentient Snowball.
I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be a Hockey Mask.
Maybe.
But yeah, I named the Lurantis Lulu, not just because Lurantis starts with the loose syllable, but also because it is like tall and lanky, which reminded me of the character designs in Code Geass, and the protagonist of Code Geass, Lelouch, is sometimes called Lulu by his friends at school.
Good.
So it all kind of loops back around.
Fantastic.
I've also seen people say that it's supposed to be like a rice ball.
Ah.
But that has nothing to do with ice.
It has ice in
it's rice.
Yeah. Saw that shit coming.
I love it.
It's based on the Orchid Mantis, which is a mantis that pretends to be an orchid, so this is an orchid that pretends to be a mantis.
Indeed.
Which doesn't really make sense. Sudowoodo makes sense, because several of the things that are good against grass types are resisted by rock. But there's not really anything... There's no real way that a grass type benefits from pretending to be a bug type.
Yeah.
Which has always kind of bugged me. Thanks, I'll I actually don't really like puns.
They're okay.
When Grant first came into my life, he was like strongly against puns, and Maggie and I would do puns. What the fuck? Maggie and I would say puns like all the time just to piss him off, and now he is the one who has become the pun master.
He broke his mind.
He is relentless and unstoppable, and it is awful and glorious.
He is also a shiny hunting fiend.
A
he's a monster. You're crazy. He broke his mind.
I like how Mein Shao is the Pokemon that Prozidi has voiced.
Yes, I was gonna say that.
Also, it's Mein Shao.
Oh, drinking that frame rate.
Woo! Spicy. Hey, hey guys, guess what? Did you know that,
Yeah, Jet Share Squeak, yeah.
Oh my god.
I don't remember if I've mentioned that Beware reminds me of strawberry flavored frosted mini wheats, but it does.
Oh. I get that.
That sounds familiar.
But weird.
It's the colors of Neapolitan ice cream, almost.
Kinda.
Slightly desaturated chocolate there, but...
Sauce. Okay, bye, Cuke.
Cuke!
God damn it. Also, I like how that... Oh, that was a good pain split. Oh, it's Machamp.
Oh, it's Ekans.
Oh, it's Mewtwo. I gotta...
You guys, figured out your teams for BDSP yet?
No. I haven't really thought about it.
I've got a few of mine planned. I think about 4 or 5, depending.
Okay. I planned my entire team, like, the day it was announced.
I think I put together a list of, like 15 things that are, like, potential.
And you're gonna have to narrow those down to 12.
Yeah, I mean, I might not go with 12. Depends.
That's your thing.
It is usually my thing, but I've gotten enough people angry at me.
But it wouldn't be you playing a Pokemon game if you didn't have a team of 12.
It would be me playing a Pokemon game prior to, like, 2010. The first time I did it was SoulSilver.
Yeah.
And the last time I did it was Wednesday.
Laha, laha.
When did you stop playing Pokemon? 98, you said?
Probably somewhere around there. It was after that, because 98 is when it came out in the US, and I didn't try it until I think Yellow was like almost released, but it not quite.
So at 99?
Probably something like that.
So you've been using Teams of 12 probably about as long as you had been. Probably about 50% of the time you've been playing. But yeah, the team I have planned is Infernape, Crobat, Golduck, Bronzong, Spiritomb, and Licky Licky. And the Crobat is going to be shiny, because I have one that I happened to find in Omega Ruby during my Mystery Egg run back in 2016. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, cool, I will use this in the Diamond and Pearl remakes when they come out. And now 5 years later, I'm going to get to use it.
I love it.
Punchy, punch, punch.
Yeah, punch, punch!
Punchy, punch, punch, punch! Yeah, Raz!
I love how the reward for that is they just explode.
Yeah!
First person in existence to use a Golduck, yeah.
the only reason I'm using a Golduck is because I used one the first time I played Platinum, and I wanted to recreate a part of the team for that. My original team in that was Infernape, Infernape, Crobat, Golduck, Porygon Z, and then I like used a Giratina, the Giratina, and then I probably just had opponent HM Slave as my final one. But I reused Porygon Z in Sun in my first run of that, so I didn't want to use that a third time, so it worked out. I ended up using, it's going to be three old things and three things I've never used before. Used an unknown? I'm so sorry. Duck only run. Let's see, how many ducks even are there in Pokemon? I don't think there's that many.
Golduck, Farfetch'd, or Sirfetch'd, I guess. Ducklet, but not Swanna. Porygon, arguably.
Yeah, I would say it's a duck.
I agree. Very ducky.
Like, Porygon 2 is explicitly based on one of those drinking birds.
Right. You are super weak to ice, I should not use you. I'm sure there's probably some other stuff that resembles ducks.
Yeah, probably.
Champ has a duck face.
It does. That's weird. Big weird eyebrows.
Entrainment. Wait, what? It said that it used entrainment, but then it didn't say what it did. Did it just fail?
Maybe. Entrainment,
it gives your ability to something else, right?
I think so,
it
yeah.
Usually has an animation that plays, but I don't think you have animations on.
Role play is the opposite. If I had to guess what happened, it tried to give its ability to Cuke, but it couldn't because it has to have innards out, I think.
Oh, maybe.
But you do have animations on.
Oh!
Okay, back to the duck only. Could you add Ditto on your team? Because like, Ditto could be a duck.
Oh, but you can only send it out against trainers using a duck.
A very situational Pokemon.
Occasional duck Saturday. No, don't recover. Does anybody else have this, like, ever notice this, where, like, you're very likely to misclick your move in a double battle compared to a single battle, because, like, I always find, like, in single battles, I don't ever, it doesn't happen very often, but in doubles, it's like, you get an extra turn to, like, go back and change your mind. It's weird.
So, like, mentally, you know you can...
Maybe. It's just like, because like right there, I hit the wrong move by mistake, and it's just like, oh, it doesn't matter, I can hit B and do it again, but yeah, it's, I don't get it.
Oh god.
Is Ludicolo a duck?
Yeah.
Necrozma, what
oh,
the
hello.
Fuck?
Necrozma is a duck. Yeah, it's a...
I have vague memories of this.
Radiation is here. People growing arms out of their heads is here now.
Can I help you?
If you do this, you will fight it, and then... Actually, I don't know if you fight it immediately.
Well, I just saved, so let's find out.
I think it fucks off, and then... No, you do fight it.
Oh, is this my one chance to catch it? I didn't expect this at all. I thought that
someone
was going
to
be a close game.
It's easy to catch.
Mm.
It'll probably come back if you beat the Elite Four, like usual.
It was a cool song.
Yeah, I like it.
I am actually planning on beastballing it.
Of course he is.
Don't get burned, please.
Yeah. If you miss the pole, your Yamper will use Bullfetch to get it back.
I think Bullfetch is an adorable trait, ability, whatever.
I like how you... I find it interesting that knowing you, that you don't consider, like, the catch power cheating.
It's because there's no evidence of it.
I see. Okay. Well, there's video proof that you did it. Yeah, I think it's a 10th usual, right? I don't know if Necrozma counts as a.
It doesn't. All right.
Nice.
That's weird. I guess they can't really. I don't know, because. The reason the Beast Ball works is it latches onto, like, ultra wormhole radiation, right?
Something like that, yeah. I think the explanation given is, like, it's been in this world long enough that it doesn't have any of that energy left.
Okay, but now it hasn't, because this thing was literally just in Ultra Megalopolis.
True. Yeah, I don't fucking know.
Cry.
This thing is weird.
Yeah, it is. Remember when people saw the first form and they're like, you can rearrange these pieces to make a dragon? And people are like, yeah, you can, what the fuck? And then...
Well, gotta name it, like, Mittens or something. No.
Yeah, you took Glalie and got moody and lost all the energy. Pokemon eating each other doesn't exist outside of the Pokedex, though.
Oh, right. Colress is in this game.
He's probably going to give you the End Solarizer and End Lunarizer, if I remember.
Do I have Cosmog yet?
Arm
I actually don't remember.
I don't remember. Ultra Megalopolis is such an awful name for an area. A little bit.
It's kind of shitty, yeah. Yeah, I'm curious now. Do I have Cosmog? I'm not going to do anything with this, but let's see. It's looking like a no. I randomly have a Stack Attacker. I think I got off the GTS. Also...
Ugh, Buzzwool.
I like the...
My nightmares!
The ripple effect when you move the system.
Yes. Except it just looks like...
Did you learn your lesson? You want to explain that one?
Okay, I don't really remember a lot of it because it was a dream, but, like, I had this, like, weird-ass fucking nightmare one night where, like, I was being chased through, like, this snowy landscape with, like, cabins and shit, and I was just being chased by Buzzwool? Like,
wait,
not actually Buzzwool, but, like, it...
Or were the different versions of cabin the viewer?
I don't know. What?
No, it was a shitty joke. Moving on.
So, like, eventually I just get fed up with this, like, running for my life shit. I'm like, fuck it. Like, just kill me. I don't care. Like, I'm not gonna deal with this anymore. This thing just, like, looks at me and is like, did you learn your lesson? And then I woke up.
Good shit. What do you mean Buzzswole is a good girl?
Oh, yeah. I've actually heard that Buzzswole is kind of like, they might be like reversing gender norms, like it's female and Pheromosa is male, because I think only female mosquitoes drink blood.
I see.
I don't know about the Pheromosa, but I don't know.
I mean, but it's not a mosquito. It's an alien that looks like a mosquito.
Yeah, I know. How about a musquitter?
No.
Yes.
Wasn't there something weird that Americans call mosquitoes sometimes? Other than skeeters?
I don't know. I can't think of any.
Okay.
Musquitter was from, like, a Civil War era letter that I saw in, like, a history book where just people couldn't fucking spell, and that was how they spelled mosquito.
Good.
It's from the same one with the guy who had a brother named J-U-H, pronounced Ho.
Good.
Wonderful. Swamp flies? No, there was some other, there was something else. Also, your dream letters with, like, the fucking, I don't care anymore, just kill me, reminds me of the dream I had, where I was just kind of milling about my house doing stuff, and, like, I realized that throughout the day, my mom had been trying to kill me.
you just realized?
Yes. Like, through strangulation.
Oh. Okay.
Alola and Marowak can learn Ice Beam. Okay.
Good. I'm like, I know you've been trying to kill me. I don't want to keep this up. Let's just get it over with, as long as you do it in a quick and painless way. And she was like, very well, and then like shot me or stabbed me or something.
Good lord.
It was pretty good.
I'll never know what lesson I was supposed to learn.
Did I mention that I was actually planning on putting that in the Hollow Knight RPG? Because remember, there was going to be the crossover, and what's her name? Lusamine was going to be in there, and there was going to be a scene with a Buzzswole chasing you, and it's totally going to have that.
Oh my god.
That's fantastic. I would have lost my shit.
Is the thing I drew in the video?
What?
Is the thing I drew in the video?
Oh, no, but I mean, I assume we would be adding it.
Okay. Yeah.
Wow!
Wow.
Collector Minty.
Is that actually his name?
Dinty Moore. Okay, do I have steel or poison?
No, there is no Hollow Knight RPG.
Yeah, I put together like a D&D campaign with Hollow Knight stuff, and I have video of it that just hasn't been edited together in any fashion, but Autumn's gonna potentially look at that.
Yeah, I offered to do that, and probably the TP rando as well, after I'm done with school stuff, in about a month. Well, more like 3.5 weeks. But...
like the light bulb.
What?
Just... whenever there was combat and we had to have, like, player tokens,
OC
was just a light bulb.
Good shit.
Can anyone, confirm? This is the most unimportant shit ever. I think in these games, you can't actually get all 5 Flabebe colors. It's kind of stupid.
Why not?
I think they're just
like just
I think you can't find them. You're not actually a grass type, but you have grass moves, fairies. Yeah, whatever.
I like when Tiso would just throw his shield and then lose it three times in a row in a combat. He just, like, rolled a one every time there was a perception check, except for the one time that he didn't and Quirrell did, and, like...
So what system did you base it on? Because I, didn't actually know.
God, I don't even remember. Was it 4th edition or 5th?
5th.
In before random 4E hatred in the chat.
Banjo 4E. Dude, come on.
Oh, you play D&D? We should talk about it sometime.
I'll talk about the time that I peed.
There was one time I was taking my players through Death House, the beginning of the Curse of Strahd campaign, and there's a monster in, like, the basement which they, like, absolutely should not be fighting, and of course they decide to fight it because it has health, we can kill it. And I fucking crit one of them. He goes down immediately, and I'm like, alright. So I move on to the next one. He attacks the thing. I roll against him, and I crit him. And instead of, like, the two characters in the back are trying to, like, open the gate to, like, make an escape route so that they can leave. And he's just like, no, I'm gonna stay here and fend it off. What's the chance that it can crit me again? And we're like, approximately 1 in 20, James. So I rolled the die and dramatically lift up the DM screen, and there's a 20, and I'm like, I'm sorry, James.
I have no good things about Curse of Strahd. But I've also heard,
like, Strahd. Like,
it's, like, intentionally very hard, which is always kind of a weird thing for D&D, because there's not much you can do about that other than hope to get lucky or just, like, avoid the hard parts. It kind of depends on how you run it. But...
yeah. Well, my players are stupid. I love them, but they're stupid. So, Strahd is, like, they have Irina, who's the girl that, like, Strahd super wants to get with, basically. And he, like, is... they're in this cabin, and he is just outside the door, like, fucking with them. Just, like, being, like, pretending he's, like, a helpless stranger needing shelter from a storm. And they, of course, are, like, super skeptical that it's Strahd, because, well, of course it's Strahd. And so this one guy walks up to the door, goes, "You can come in if you take off your hood." And so Strahd just goes, okay, takes off his hood and steps in, because he had just been invited in.
Right.
And the druid's just grabbing her, like, staff in the background, like, you fucked up. I love them, but they make me describe awful things.
Yeah, he specifically wanted to finish a bunch of Pokemon games that he hadn't they'd left unfinished for a while, so a couple weeks ago it was Let's Go, last week it was Shield, this week it's this.
Yeah, he seemed to really have a thing for me having unfinished projects. It's weird.
I kind of get it, though. It's, I mean, I'm not the same, but I do obsess over the details of, like, your history of videos and shit. Yeah, I've never actually run, like, a pre-made module. I've been DMing since
Tuesday.
Since December 2017, and all I've done is run the same campaign that's been going for 3.5 years now, and a one-shot, and that's pretty much it. There was also, like, another... No, sorry, it wasn't a one-shot, it was, like, a mini-campaign with, like, 6 sessions, maybe 5.
I see.
And then a one-shot, and that was pretty much it.
Next week might actually be letters finishing black and white, except that would be like a little bit too much. I think I still have like a couple gym leaders to fight. At least
one. Yeah,
maybe
one. Not finishing. I will say we won't be able to do like same time next week because I do have like the first day of my new job starts on Monday. I don't actually know what the hours are. But we can do something sometime next week. I'll let you know my schedule as soon as I know it.
That's fine. I'm done classes on Friday, so like any time is good for me after that. Until I start my practicum, but eh.
Next week I can do any time. The week after that, I don't know exactly because I have exams starting that week. And I think most of them are such that, like, I can...
I do not remember Pyroar being in this game.
Yeah, me neither. Maybe one of the ones I had in Ultra.
I think one of the Elite Four has one.
I think they're such that...
Wait, no, that's actually
fine. I think it's such that it's like, here is the day you have to do it. When you start, you have this amount of time to do it, but you can do it at any point during the day or whatever. Something like that.
That's not bad.
Anyway, new job is Jersey Mike's sandwich shop. Nothing impressive.
Well, I'm proud of you.
Well, you shouldn't be.
It is definitely better than the Pizza Hut that is like 2 hours out of your way every day.
Yeah. I still have not told Martin I got a new job because I am embarrassed.
Why are you embarrassed? Just because it's like a side grade, basically?
Yeah.
Ah, whatever. It's still
it's
better for you.
It's absolutely an upgrade of a job. It's
like
an
overall.
Upgrade in everything that you need it to be other than not being... anything different, really.
Yeah, I guess.
Should've left Pizza Hut to go work in the oil fields. You forgot about the part where he would replace the money in the cash register with a bunch of counterfeits.
Actually, I think we did get a counterfeit bill a couple weeks ago, but it was only one.
Really?
Piece of cheese on top of walls. What would it be like a tampered shrimp? Okay, I'll just stop talking.
Is that supposed to be tempura shrimp?
Probably.
I have a pin on my server that just says what my record is for the most prawns eaten at this like Chinese buffet place that my family likes. And they update it whenever I eat more and break my record.
Good.
But I haven't broken it in a couple of years.
This thing has refresh, I'm gonna be mildly upset.
To be fair, I haven't been able to go there in like a year because of Backstreet Boys reunion concert, but...
What the fuck?
No.
You still cannot hear the game at all. Are you fucking kidding me?
Ultima, this is always just you, apparently.
Is anybody else having the problem that they can't hear the game? Because I asked before. I said I could turn it up if I needed to. Like, I'm not hearing the stream. I'm only hearing the mix in, like, my headphones. Can just about hear.
Okay. Hold on.
I can
I have the stream open. I can check from the stream if I just mute myself.
Yeah, it's just you, Ultima.
Well, one person said they can just about hear, which means it's pretty quiet, so we'll see.
I'm just saying, this is the thing last time where everyone else in chat was like, yeah, the stream audio is fine. He's like, well, I know better.
I never want to have it, like, because the game audio isn't that important, so I never want to have it drown anyone out. Mm-hmm. But here, I will turn it up a little bit, and if anybody complains, then you will get hit with a wet fish.
Whack! You've been whacked with a wet trout.
Herring sandwich.
Should I get ice cream or milk and cookies?
Milk and cookies.
Okay. Be right back.
False.
Oh,
try
wet
cod,
me,
please,
Oreos.
Oh please.
I like try wet cod, anyway.
The only thing I've eaten today was part of a I think it was like a third of a pint of ice cream and a candy bar. I have not eaten anything healthy today.
I have had some hickory sticks.
Those are fake.
You're fake.
Okay, but is the game volume actually two left?
I don't know how to measure that.
Whenever that noise occurs, you know that there's monkeys coming. I've got nothing. North
like
left.
Like flying monkeys? Are you like the Wicked Witch?
No, I'm Glenda.
Glinda.
Spotlight. I have no idea what this move is. It's for multi-battles, I don't give a shit. Is Claydol like a plastic bag owl in the wind or whatever the fuck?
Like the plastic owl in the wind.
Was that actually what it was? I don't even remember what you said.
No, I can never remember what it is until I actually, like, look up the quote. So I'm going to go look up the quote.
Okay.
I'll get back to you.
I don't remember if I was at full health when it attacked me. Let's see. There we go. Any excuse to use Pain Split. It is a cool move.
I'm an owl floating like plastic bag in Jind, which is wind spelt incorrectly.
How is it spelled?
E-J-N-D.
Oh, good. I enjoyed that flinch. I'm glad that I'm using Cuke. It is difficult to use, but I find it interesting. It's just it's basically just a better WoW of it. The volume is cubed. The prize is priced. So I already forgot where I was going in this place. Like, this place is not big or confusing, but I'm, like, forgetting where I'm going every time there's a battle, so it's confusing enough. Let's see. I think I might have come from over... Okay, yeah, did I fight you? No. Haul my luggage. Yeah, I've got a bit of money. That's what happens when you send Pokemon on like treasure hunting expeditions a lot and just sell a bunch of shit that they find. Yeah, cool matchup. Thousand arrows hits flying types, right? Yeah, Volt Switch when you only have one Pokemon. Also, what are you doing here with one Pokemon?
Ismolga.
I like the theory behind Imolga's name. It's like, the Japanese name is Imonga, and it has something to do with, like, the scientific name of flying squirrels, but then they had to change it for English because Hmong was considered a racial slur.
Oh, I see. Not one that I've heard of, but alright.
Mongolians, I guess. I come from... Yeah, I think I came from here. I mean, yeah, Stone Edge would have worked, but... Ground has stab. Sometimes they stab. Wait, it has to do with Down Syndrome? What the hell? So did you play through, like, the original Sun or Moon and the Ultras, or, like, what did you do with this generation?
Yeah, I did both. I'm pretty sure I picked Moon for both because I enjoyed Lunala much more than Solgaleo, or however you say it.
Yeah. I like Moon better too, but I figured I'd go with opposite versions.
Which is also valid.
Yeah, I think most people just kind of agree that the, wait, what the hell is my zoom move here? I don't know, whatever. There just wasn't enough of a gap between the release. I think it was only 1 year, and the games are, like, barely fucking changed.
Yeah, it was basically just the same game again.
With, like, a couple things towards the end changed. Which, I mean, yeah, it's Pokemon, they do that. But, I don't know, this one just always felt particularly, like, unneeded. With a worse story. Yeah, I've heard that.
Well, like, they could have done, like, something, like a third game or something if they wanted to do that, but... I don't know.
It's a British term, huh? We'll have to ask. Yeah, I've not seen anything of Rainbow Rocket. I'm kind of curious what that's all about. Yeah, pretty much. There's way too many Psychic and Dragon Legendaries. And I like Psychic types. I like most of the Psychic Legendaries. But, there are quite a few of them. Okay, is that up there? I assume that's the exit. I'm just checking if that's the only thing.
I like going into the Ultra Den and having the, like, legendaries type hint be psychic, and I'm like, well, that could be anything.
Oh, yeah. I remember before X and Y came out, people were like, oh man, Veltal's totally a sound type because it was the only thing in the trailer that made a noise, and they wouldn't just make a new type for one of the legendaries and not the other. And then it kind of wasn't. I still think sound type would be cool, but the reasoning on that one was a little, you know, bad.
Well, Ariel, I guess you could say... You never had a leg to stand on.
The hell?
Welcome back.
I have a question that you might have input on.
Sure.
Is Hmong a term for people with Down syndrome there?
I think so.
What the fuck?
I'm just looking through the... Yeah. Oh, are you talking about, like, Imolga? Yeah. Because it's short for, like, mongrel, right? Which is, like... You know, a mongrel is a dog that is, like, the opposite of a purebred, where it has so many different breeds in it that it's, like,
people consider it like kind of muddled and ugly looking, and I guess that kind of association is, you know, it's like, oh, you know, these people look different from usual, so.
Okay.
I can't say I've like heard it a lot, but I think that's the case, yeah. That said,
are we going to talk about Spastic?
Yes, I got to do this, okay? Because
yeah,
I got to clear the air here.
Yeah, and disclaimer: we are not using this term to refer to any particular individual, so therefore it shouldn't be considered offensive.
So, a few months ago, I don't remember the context, but you were looking at the fan server, right?
Yeah.
And somebody made a joke saying something about Autumn as in the season, and then someone was like, oh, she hasn't been here in a while. And then,
I think I just posted I think what happened was just, like, you said something funny, and I just screenshotted and posted it there.
Oh, that was right. Yeah, yeah. And people, like, I was thinking of a different instance, and people were like, why are we being subjected to Autumn? And then you got mad at that, and told me, and you're like, you should say something offensive. And I'm like,
and I was like, you should say something not actually offensive.
Oh, that was it. Yeah, not like, actually offensive. I'm like, not actually offensive. Let me think. How about Spastic because of the Mario Party 8 thing? Because for those who don't know, there was in Mario Party 8, there's a train level where Magic Koopa or Kamek or something can like fuck with the train with magic. And it does some little rhyme that ends with, like, make this train go spastic or something. And it got, like, recalled in the UK over, like, concerns that this could be construed as, like, derogatory to disabled people or something. And this is hilarious because, like, no. No one would take it that way. And it's stupid, and it's not even really offensive here. Like, it's funny because it's a ratings board being overly paranoid, basically. That's the story.
But somehow, yeah, allegedly, everyone in the UK considers it like a horrible word that you should never use.
What happened is, I said this because you told me to say something not actually offensive, and I thought, I'll reference the Mario Party 8 thing. Even in the screenshot, you can see me saying because of the Mario Party 8 thing. He posts this, and then people on the server go fucking crazy, and they're like, I can't believe she'd say that. Like, she's in
knowing
the UK,
perfectly well.
Yeah, that choice of words was deliberate. She knows exactly how offensive it is. I'm like, yeah, I know how offensive it is. Not.
It's not. I mean, I don't actually know one way or the other, but I take your word for it.
Other people might disagree. I don't know what to say. Like, as somebody who has lived here for, you know, fucking 20 years, I have heard the word in several contexts, and no one's ever really gotten mad about it. You know, it's like, you know, I'm neurodivergent or whatever the fuck you want to call it, and so, you know, I would be the kind of person that would be probably, you know, this word used against if it was actually offensive to, like, you know, people that are neurodivergent or whatever. Ooh, that's bad. Just pissed me off, because I went out of my way to pick something that was not offensive and explain. But yeah, you are also yeah, it's like, I don't know, it might be a regional thing. I would say, yeah, obviously it's not even offensive at all in America. And I would say it's not offensive here either, based on my experience as a British person. I don't know what to say.
Hello, I'm a British person.
It just bothered me that I went out of my way to pick something not offensive and then point out that I was referencing the stupid Mario Party 8 controversy.
Yeah,
like,
I'm
everyone,
still not mad at
everyone makes fun of this as being like, oh haha, silly rating board being overly paranoid. And then someone was actually like, oh my god.
I did see a video talking about it where they're like, I don't even want to use the word, but I have to because I have to talk about it, so I'm really sorry. And it's like, oh my god.
Oh my god. Yeah, there's definitely way worse things you could say.
The bottom line is people are too fucking sensitive.
That, and I feel like I'm a big proponent of the idea that, like, context is the most important thing, and you should probably be able to say anything as long as you're not actually trying to be offensive. Like, you can say words that are totally normal in an offensive way, and you can say offensive words in a non-offensive way. Sorry to go on another ramble here, but just as an example, like, the word man is not offensive. Men exist, and you can call them men.
obviously calling a trans woman a man is offensive, but it's the context that makes it offensive, not the word itself, right? So, this, you know, I just feel like, why can't people be more willing to be like, you know, look at it on a case-by-case basis, basically. Like, is this person actually trying to be a dick, or are they just happening to say a thing that someone could construe badly, and therefore we have to punish them? Like, that's fucking stupid. So I'm gonna get off my soapbox now.
11 soaps. That was my addition to that.
12 soaps.
12 of them. 13, y'all.
13.
Not sure how to recover from that side story. What the hell does rant mean? I remember that quote. I don't remember the context of it.
Oh, the Alolan Vulpix.
Alolan Vulpix is pretty cute.
I'm tempted to ask Kyle J. Berg, people where have some issues, but I kind of don't want to open a can of worms potentially, so.
Alright, well, I guess that was victory chode. Lol, it was funny. Is it okay to tell you a story rather passionately? If you're gonna word it like that, I don't know, but okay.
Did you understand well the information I just told you?
Be you a ghost or a figment of my imagination, I don't care. Or whatever it is he says.
Short for Rantaro. Amami?
Alright. Yeah, noises.
What do you have?
Cookies. Because I asked, should I have ice cream or milk and cookies? And you said cookies. And for some reason I like other people choosing things for me at certain opportunities.
I understand. Especially when it's like a choice like that, that really doesn't matter.
There's Lion's Wrath. Just a worse earthquake, okay. Speaking of earthquake.
Rontaro seems like the type of character you would like, Alicina.
I like Thousand Arrows. I'm thinking of getting rid of Stone Edge for Outrage. I think Stone Edge is a TM, right? I can just reteach it if I want to.
I think so.
If not, I mean, it's either a TM or it's a move it learned naturally. It's definitely not an egg move on a legendary, so yeah, let's just do it.
Even if it's an egg move, you'd be able to relearn it.
Okay.
If it had already learned it.
Oh, Lanzarote doesn't hit allies. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't really matter for single battles, then. Thousand Arrow is easily the best offensive move in the game. Really. Is ground really that good? Like, I always thought it was weird how they have so many different ways to, like, nullify ground attacks, and then ways to nullify things that nullify ground attacks. I'm like, why is there this weird arms race for this one type? Anyway, I do kind of want to trade over and, like, change the form of this thing, so let's actually do that. I do have my other 3DS here, because I was expecting having to do this.
Key change mofo.
Piece of chill leaf, and
I mean, it doesn't evolve into a snake and then a Power Ranger. It's nice. Also, it's not a Power Ranger, it's obviously a mecha. I think I mentioned this, but when I was a kid,
I definitely told Josh about this. I don't know if I mentioned this on stream. When I was a kid, in the place I lived in London, so this would have been like mid-2000s, for some reason, the stereotypical thing that young boys were into was Power Rangers. I have no idea why.
I fucking love Power Rangers.
I always hated it.
I was never interested. What is Zygarde? It's a bunch of cell things.
It's part of the, like, the Tree of Life thing that Xerneas and Yveltal came. It's like some Norse mythology thing, right?
Yeah, I think it's like Jormungandr or something. Yeah, I think ground is like a weirdly good offensive type, and electric is a weirdly good defensive type. Just because it's only weak to ground.
Oh no, the Ferium Z will be removed if you trade the Pokemon.
Oh, you're so funny, baby boo.
I did change the info, right?
I'm pretty sure you did.
If you actually didn't, then... Yeah, I definitely did, because I remember it saying that, like, the tags for it included open world.
What? Ultrasun?
Yes.
No.
Yeah, Naps the Bloop, yeah.
Naps the Bloop! It's Bloopy!
This one is just being held onto as collateral. I'm funny.
Route 34, more like Rule 34, especially with those three sisters.
Alright, now let's see, how am I gonna do this? Oh boy.
Goodness.
Alright, where do I go with the- actually, it might just- is it in the inventory, or do I have to go somewhere?
Both of us have been in the other, like, playing Pokemon game streams the past couple weeks. Where have you been?
Change form. Oh, it doesn't have power construct.
Oh.
You need that to become 100% form?
Shit. Ooh, do I have to, like, take it to that place and, like, deconstruct it and reconstruct it? I think that would probably, like, that would get rid of its level and everything, wouldn't it?
I don't know.
I guess if that's not possible, then I won't do it, but that's kind of lame. Does anyone know how that works? Let me, try to go to the place. Does anyone actually remember where the place is? It's like, I know it's just like some random shack somewhere. Should be able to add cells to make it.
Oh, further. Yeah, it's, you want to go to,
Is it near Tapu Village, or...?
It's near Tapu Village, yeah, you go west from there.
Okay. Oh wait, this is League. Shit. Yeah, flying the wrong way. Flying to the wrong way.
Secret of the way to even before.
I'm liking this setup I have here. This is,
I'm enjoying that we're also just getting the Pokemon Center music.
Yeah. Here, now you'll get both.
Oh god, oh, god. No.
Yes. Gotta do it. Okay, so going left from here.
I don't think it's a cell reference. In what, like... It's made of cells, and I guess you could say the 100% form kind of looks
route
like cell,
16.
But it also kind of just looks like a giant mecha, so...
Okay, hold on. I'm being told Route 16 now. I don't know where that one
oh,
is.
Oh, that's a little further ahead.
Oh, yeah, actually this is the place. Let me just fly there directly. Sorry,
if you
go,
you can fly there directly, no mind.
Yeah, I don't remember shit. After this, we gotta do Pokemon Shuffle with the camera.
Oh, oh god.
No, we're not doing that, don't worry. Why are there spinders here?
Because they are spinduses.
What is assembly? What is separation? what the fuck?
using Zygarde in the Zygarde queue, I guess. Please select Zygarde.
I mean, okay.
What the fuck? What? What?
Oh my god.
Have you not? Did you not collect every Zygarde cell?
No. I thought I only needed 50%.
50?
Yeah. I've collected 93 of 100.
Oh. Huh. Yeah.
Is that not enough?
It should be for 50%. I thought you were banking 100%.
I mean, 100 is just like... That's like a form that it only gets, like, for the... And then it, like, changes after it takes damage, right?
I don't remember. Ultima, there is a guy that sells custom-made ones, and that's pretty much the only way to do it, unless you want to go via the homebrew method, but that one's kind of more unreliable from my experience.
I will be right back, guys.
It's a lot easier and cheaper to do the homebrew method.
I saved before doing this, because I assume, like, yeah, this is gonna... Oh my fucking god.
Isn't it the other way around? Doesn't it stay complete as long as it doesn't drop below half? That would make more sense. You've been looking at 3dscapture.com, they have them. Is that the guy that makes the custom ones? If they don't have them, then you're probably shit out of luck unless you do the homebrew method. Which, Dante uses it, and he's gone like perfect quality streams, whereas I've done it, and it frequently drops frames and is generally low quality. I think it might just be because my internet sucks.
You know
so
what?
I would,
let's do it.
I'd recommend looking into homebrew method.
It's like I'm taking this thing apart and putting it back together, but I want to see if it works. If it doesn't, I'll just reload it. But you know, that's kind of the whole thing of this, the whole point of this Pokemon, anyway.
Mm.
What do you mean the 10%? What the fuck? Okay. It's like how you want to assemble it, using the Zygarde cube only because I don't have one. Assembled with the cores and cells, okay.
Do you want me to time out Baby Boo for asking about insert political thing here again?
No, it's fine. Maybe it's because I don't have all the cores? I don't get why this doesn't work.
You should only need 50 for a...
Can I... Hold on, do I have another one in this game that I can, like, disassemble, maybe?
That might be what happened.
Let's see. Yeah, sure enough.
For the record, separating a Zygarde is much the same as releasing a Pokemon. It is essentially lost, including any moves it learned or ribbons it earned.
Yeah, I saw that. I can reteach the moves. It's just the thing that would be lost is, like, you know, the nature and everything. So I'd basically just be using a brand new one, which is kind of stupid. I wanted to see if it would actually, like, what would happen if I did it. I still might reload. How many are in the cube? I don't know. I don't know how to tell.
It said 93 when you opened it.
Okay. There we go. Do the thing. Wait, what? Oh, I don't... I'm stupid. This is a very weird process.
Yeah. Apparently you can actually get more than 100 cores if you bring in Zygarde from other games and repeatedly disassemble them. And it can hold up to 999.
Might not actually have to separate it.
No, you don't.
Actually,
it does say that.
Yeah, that's true. If I disassemble. Okay, let me restart this.
Restart
thing
the out. System. Yeah. Thumb.
Clearly, I will now get the switch involved.
Yes.
Okay, let's try this again.
I'm hyped.
This is incredibly fucking awkward, because I'm having to hold up one system while controlling the other.
Mm-mm. Are either of y'all three going to get Pokemon Snap 2? I am not.
And we were going to probably... I'm not. We were going to go through that together, though, and potentially stream it or something. It's a matter of,
It's only one, then?
Getting the computer to actually do it. Can we see the strong bad face?
Looks like I'm gonna have a good job!
Yeah. Sorry, this is a very irritating process. It also, involves... That was it, just involves.
Involves memes.
Who can't live a life without memes? No, not assembly. Oh my god. Okay. Separate. The
Wait,
50.
What? Oh, right.
So if I can get the cells. Okay. Use that and the cube.
Hello.
Hadoos. I'm still doing this shit, because it is very confusing. There we go. That is what I wanted to do.
I've been informed that there's about an hour until supper, so I might have to go early.
Okay, did that work? I think it did.
Yeah.
It's, yeah, okay. Also, it is from Kif. I don't know if anyone remembered that.
I did.
Because I sure as hell didn't. Okay, let's trade back.
And also...
What?
That's it.
Okay.
That's the joke.
Dear pesky letters.
I always forget you can connect by doing that. I always go through Festival Plus.
Oh, I've never had to make a decision.
Take some initiative for once in your life. You don't remember what that's a reference to?
I don't think I do now. You gonna let me know?
I was hoping to wait until anyone in chat, so...
Oh.
Alright, chat.
Okay, that was a diversion. So yeah, definitely playing Pokemon Shuffle. Okay. So now that that has happened, I guess we're ready to see how this goes. The fuck? Oh, okay.
I remember this guy.
I guess that is a thing I've not done.
I think there's some in the post game, I think that's why. Always confuses me when people say that Sun and Moon doesn't have a post game. Because I'm like, it has a quest and it has a set of areas that you can only access in the post game. What more do you want? It feels like anything less than the second region, people are just like. It feels like anything less than the second region, people are like, no post game. Because, like, people will lump in, like, X and Y, which legitimately has no post-game, with, like, this and Gen 4.
I can't decide if Kukui is the worst or best professor.
I fucking love him.
I like his cheesiness, but I also kind of hate his cheesiness. I don't know.
The whole thing there where he said, like, his soul burns brighter, like a blast burn or something. Yeah. Reminded me of how in One Piece, canonically, I think Sanji can use the like technique where he like spins his leg really, like he spins his leg really fast and it like sets on fire and hits the opponent or whatever. And the reason he can use that move without hurting himself is that like the fire inside his soul burns brighter than the the fire on his leg.
I do like the throwback to Lance.
Well, here we are, kid.
Sycorus.
Answer Rotom.
Sycamore's personality is being.
Oh my
a twink.
God! Please, please.
Actually, he's not really a twink. Yeah, no, he's not really a twink. Never mind. You know me. He is like.
I should do the
slender and handsome, but. I'm not hip enough with the kids to like know what word would describe him.
Vietnamese crystal playthrough when?
Eggy drug bag fuck.
BRB.
Sycamore's personality is being French. The other day, someone posted a screenshot that had like French UI in it, and I said to them, "Why are you French?" And they said, "I live in Quebec." And I said, "Why do you live in Quebec?"
This is music. There's like weird water drop noises on it.
Oh yeah.
But only Marowak.
Okay. I forgot about that thing. In this game, they just had that weird gimmick where they mentioned the first Pokemon in your party, and they dropped it for Gen 8.
I think Gen 8 did it a few times. I remember Hop doing it in the stream last week.
Oh, okay. I don't remember.
This looked like rock type, so... Alright, let's see how this goes. I think I'm 10 levels below where I should be. Or 10 levels lower than them, at least.
Well, they're like mid to late
50s. Oh, you're steel. Yeah, this is fine. Are they? I thought you said they went up to like 63.
Nope. I don't know about the fights afterwards, but Elite Four is 56, 57.
Okay, well, let's go with you for steel.
Is Hop the worst rival or the least good rival?
I mean, the worst rival is just the lack of one in Gen 3.
Yeah.
Because I don't really count Wally, and Brendan and May are like... Eh.
They're more your rival in Auras.
Man Molane.
See, I would undeniably say Wally is the rival, but you fight him twice and one of them is not a serious battle, so that barely counts. Brendan and May do not get their starter's final evolution in Ruby and Sapphire. I don't know if they do in Emerald, but they do in Auras.
Okay, I don't think they do in Emerald.
There was some kind of buff to them, or like extra fight or something.
Oh, wait, hold on. Do I have... Okay. Wait, where's my... Oh, yeah. I didn't even realize I had a Rock Head, so Flare Blitz is actually like super good on this.
Oh, neat.
Goes to use a different move.
Well, yeah, because if Flare Blitz is too good, you can finish it off with Bone Ring.
Finish it off with Force
Swipe.
Finally
go in Emerald? Okay. Fury Swipes. Yeah, that's one of the reasons I like Auras better than Emerald. Also, hot take. So everyone's like, oh, Heart Gold and Soul Silver are the best remakes. Auras sucks, and Fire and Leaf Green are pretty good. I like Fire and Leaf Green, but I prefer Let's Go. And I like Auras, and I don't like Heart Gold, Soul Silver, and I prefer Crystal, like, quite a bit. And I've told you this, and you're like, don't say that on a Pokemon subreddit.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, people get hard over HGSS. It's like, I think they're good games. I'd say they're...
I would say they're good.
I wouldn't call them the best ever, but I mean, they're up there. But yeah, the level curve does fucking suck, though.
Pokemon at a baseline is good, but among Pokemon games, it's probably... it's down there for me.
I'm just gonna get the burn here.
It's not as bad as Gen 1 or 8, but...
it's a shiny, yeah. Okay, well, you're using up your Z-move on me.
That's the problem. Not only did they not fix Johto's level curve...
but they made it worse.
Yeah. And people never fucking acknowledge this. They always say, oh, Gen 2 has a bad level curve.
I have seen people acknowledge it, but they're like, oh, but the game's still so good, and then...
I just... that game is a fucking... it's miserable to play through.
That did not get burned. That's lame.
Yeah, Gen 2 is not great.
Cuke, let's go.
I feel like there's potential there, though, which is why I was... which is why we're doing the...
Are you going to hack my computer? I'm calling the police.
It should. Maybe Pokemon was always bad.
It's just mass hallucinations.
Yes.
Oh no, my speed fell.
I'm making a similar joke.
Man, why do people hate Magnezone?
Oh yeah, I don't know.
I think Magnezone.
It's very forgettable for me.
I'm gonna ask Melody right now because she hates Magnezone.
Oh. See, I've always heard people like lump all of the Gen 4 evolutions together as just every one of them is bad because they're fat and ugly, and it's like,
yeah, I've heard that.
Okay, there's like a couple that I would agree with that, but like, there's some cool ones. Like, what's wrong with Magnezone?
Why do you hate Magnezone again? She's not actually online right now.
Okay.
If she responds, I will.
It's like. Like, Magneton, I get it. Like, yeah, it's magnets, so it called in more of itself. It makes sense. It's not a great design, but it makes sense. This one takes that idea and makes it cooler, because it fuses them together and makes it like a UFO thing. It's just, it's neat. Is that sturdy? Yeah. What would you categorize the Gen 4 evolutions of past Gen Pokemon? I just call them the Gen 4 evolutions. People know what you mean when you say that.
To make it more complex than that.
No, it's like, they are the evolutions of previous Pokemon that are introduced between numbers 387 and 493.
Oh my god. That was a good noise. Oh yay, Cuke.
Oh shit, Metagross. 1,000 arrows again. Because it'll be good. Is this song in Smash?
I don't know.
Why are you asking?
I don't know, I just...
maybe the police?
It sounds like it would be. Okay, I guess we're gonna be, potion stalling for a bit here.
I agree with your logic of Steel being good against Dragon, but... it's supposed to not have many weaknesses, so... I think it's fine as it is. And try to watch Rugrats, okay?
Hey.
I do feel like Dragon would make more sense as an offensive type than a defensive type. And it sort of is, because it's not resisted by anything except Steel and immune carries immune to it.
Yeah.
But
But at the same time,
let's just outrage whatever's coming in next turn. Why not?
The fact that it's not super effective against every other itself kind of sucks.
I always get so used to like, oh, like, oh, I can, it's okay if I heal, but if the opponent does it, then it's like, I always forget that they can. And then that causes
issues. They never heal more than 4 times per battle, though, right?
I'm not sure. The horizontal meteor. Oh, God.
God damn it, no.
Let's see.
Please never call it that.
Okay, you know what we're doing here? We're sitting in Cuke, healing, and then gonna kill this thing with innards out.
Love it.
That would be epic. Hello.
Yeah, by followers and viewers on inlink.ru/rzwa.
Oh, that wasn't a one-hit kill. Okay. Fuck. Can I... With a good damage roll, I can take another one of those. Let's try to counter it. Damn it. Oh, well.
Oh.
And is that okay.
Yeah, there is always one. It's one per stream.
Fire Fang. I don't know if that will one-hit kill it, but we'll try.
You doing okay?
Me? Yes.
Good. You just been quiet.
I am here.
Fiddle the dot. I know that me going through the Elite Four in games 3 weeks in a row is super exciting, so.
No, I'm more of just very fried at the moment.
Understandable.
You still have a bunch of crap due later.
I'm down to... I think I've got 4 things due. I've got one more of those stupid little Excel assignments. I've got the final that I'm working on, the 7-page research paper, and then I have the Excel final, and that's on Friday. So, slowly getting it down. But the next couple things are still very big.
You can do it. I was basically in your shoes 2 weeks ago. I had stuff due like every day that week, and every couple days. Why is fried not exactly a great word to describe yourself?
What the hell?
Like slang for high, or because I know like baked and
bake you hot, BB. Gotta say it.
Fuck.
Piddle on the hottest, baby.
The fresh breeze movement.
How would the Sword and Shield gym music be in Smash Ultimate if Sword and Shield came after Smash Ultimate? They'll probably add it with either a Gen 8 Pokemon in the Fighter Pass, God forbid, or in the next Smash game. Someone explain what Borax.
What are we explaining?
Oh, the bake you hot it BB thing.
Uh-huh.
It was just a creepy ass comment that she got on Reddit.
Yeah.
I guess that is an Aussie slang thing, yeah. Because I never heard of it, and neither has the Yank or the Canuck in this call.
Did you call me a Canuck?
I thought it was Canuck.
I thought it was Canuck.
Well, speaking of Canuck, my friend saw a small little black kitty and his name was Canuck, and he sent me a bunch of pictures of him, and I love this cat.
And then it died.
No! What the fuck?
Well, all cats have to be dead.
Knucklehead!
Oh good, I'm gonna use a potion for 3 HP. Yeah. Oh, I didn't buy more regular potions. Oh.
I have used a serviette lately, thank you.
A what?
We're in a weird position because
it's serviette.
It's the British and I suppose Canadian word for a napkin. Except over here people usually use napkin, but serviette is like the proper posh way of posh word for it.
I usually say napkin. But certain things are serviettes.
A Chesterfield.
Let's see what other types are down here.
My Baba has a Chesterfield.
Oh yeah, I forgot about Chesterfields.
Is your shenotic proof that you are a weed smoker?
I mean,
we just have a wonderful chat today, don't we? Kidding, love you guys.
Okay, this one is actually rock.
Yep. So when I said that, like, it wasn't the same, it's just that one. The other three are the same.
Oh. So, rock, flying, and...
Ghost.
Oh, okay.
It would be dog, but, like, Nanu turned down the position and Acerola went instead.
Mm.
I didn't know it was pronounced like that. Yeah, it's pronounced Acerola.
I didn't know it was pronounced like that.
I was just basically in before I'm in the chat.
Yes. Penny farthing.
Okay, well, to be fair, that's how the flower is said. is squeeze. What was your story with the word squeeze? I know you have one.
Oh god, do I? I seem to remember somebody using that word in reference to, like, me in a relationship. I don't remember the context.
Oh god. You always get halfpence confused with penny farthing. Well, penny farthing was like a type of magazine, right? And halfpence is exactly what it sounds like, half a pence. I might be wrong though.
I thought it was a halfpenny.
Well, did I say halfpence? Well, yeah, because they said half.
Okay, thanks.
It's halfpenny or halfpence, depending on if you spell it with any or with ends. Main squeeze.
What did it eat? Excisor?
Oh, it might be a kind of bike. I might be confusing it with something else. Yeah, let me. I think you're right. I think it is a kind of bike. What about a velocipede?
Velocipede? What?
That was like an old term for one of the old. Because, like, the bike wasn't just invented in a day, you know, there were several iterations and, like, designs people came up with, and one of them was called a velocipede.
Oh, yeah, the velocipede.
Okay, yeah, penny farthing is a type of bike. Let me look up velocipede. Okay, so a bicycle is a type of velocipede. Velocipedes include, it's the general term for unicycles, bicycles, tricycles, monowheels.
Monowheels. Oh. How the hell is that different from a unicycle? Oh, wait, shit, wasn't there a unicycle story? Like...
I don't know.
Oh, yeah, my friend Erica from class got a unicycle. But, I mean, Autumn can finish her story first.
Oh, just... a monowheel is just the kind where you're inside the wheel. It's, like, big enough
to... Oh, so it's the thing that Mr. Garrison made that you operate with like, a dildo up your ass. Okay.
What?
Yeah, it's... Don't worry about it. It'll change the way that they design. It'll change the way that they design cities.
Are you just pretending to be one of those posh motherfuckers? Okay, one, I don't pretend to be posh at all. Two, I don't think most people here know what a penny farthing is. And three, I'm only British when it's convenient to me because I wasn't born here.
Well, yeah, because you were excommunicated from Russia.
No, it was from Turkey, allegedly, but no, I'm from Slovakia, and my parents are from Slovakia, and my grandparents and up are from Hungary, so I'm, like, roughly half Slovak.
Well, guess we're sitting through the bullet seat animation again, because I was expecting to just die that turn, but okay. It won't be enough to kill it, but whatever.
I'm loving this animation where he just kind of hops up into the air.
Yeah.
With his mouth open, stays still as bullets fly from slightly.
And then, yeah,
mouth,
just keeps doing it over and over.
Out and then does it again.
Stone miss. Okay, let's go with even more bullet seats.
Hooray!
This is so fucking stupid. Yeah, didn't the stadium games? They show the animation once, but then they show the opponent getting hit like five times or whatever. That is a lot less awkward. That was some good shit. Are we gonna get to see it against the next Pokemon that comes out?
I forgot you named the stream Penguin Altaria Succotash.
Oh yeah.
Do you know what's a thing that, like, upsets me a little bit, is that all the great stream titles that you come up with get lost to history, because you only keep the VOD and not, like, the details of the stream.
Okay, you know what? Your 2 HP might be helpful to me later, so...
It's the same as how I wish that I...
Oh, maybe I can burn
like,
it.
...documented all the stupid, like, usernames and nicknames on Discord I've had and stuff like that.
Okay. Eat up the Z-move, and probably don't get burned in the process.
Continental Crush.
You can glide! Let me just get crushed by all of Brazil here.
This kills them all.
Alright. Vignette kinda needs health. Let's see.
Will you play Pip again?
I mean, Kyuk is like my go-to sacrificial thing. I don't think I'm at that
Man
point quite
Kyuko's yet. Garage. Sacrificial cucumber.
No.
If you're using a Rapidash, you could have jumped over that rock.
God.
Wasn't it Ponyta that could jump over the Great Wall of China
or Ayers Rock or Air? I don't know how you pronounce
Air.
It.
Yeah.
It can also trample anything flat in seconds with its hooves that are 10 times harder than diamonds. Like, dude, calm down. It's
a
fucking horse.
I like the 10 times harder.
I like, can't Blaziken jump over the Empire State Building or something?
Some stupid shit
something
like that.
Something ridiculous.
I think maybe the Eiffel Tower, but yeah, still.
I mean, Uluru and Ayers Rock are the same thing, right? It's just one's the, like, filthy colonial name and one is the Aborigine name.
Oh, what was the Cradily meme?
Oh, best friend, boyfriend, girlfriend, friend. They all end with end, but Cradily ends with ILY for I love you. If you love your Cradily, share this in the U wall.
Okay.
Worst.
I fucking love that picture. Hang on, let me see if I can find it.
Primeape gets so angry it literally dies as a result.
I like that one.
Yeah. God, the fucking Gen 7 Pokedex entries are so edgy for no reason.
The one where, like, is it Salamence or Garchomp? And the Mega Form is, like, in extreme pain all the time and needs to rapidly, like, viciously cut things to pieces so as to not be full of anguish.
Well, I think it's, like, Salamence, like, will, like, fly with its razor-sharp wings and cleave through anything it's in its path, including its own trainer. It is dubbed, like, the blood-soaked crescent. And then Garchomp flies around and swallows entire flocks of bird Pokemon.
There was
like,
one
Jesus
like,
Christ.
This thing is in extreme pain all the time, and I'm like, wow.
Well, their Mega Scizor is constantly melting and has to, like, beat its wings to try and cool itself down ineffectively or something.
Should you feel yourself attacked by a sudden chill, it is evidence of an approaching Gengar. There is no escaping it. Give up. That one has the energy of the fucking, SC Dex descriptions.
Yeah, kinda.
Why can I not find the Cradily image? I'm, like, upset. I swear I saved this thing.
I know you sent it to me a while ago.
I know, but I don't want to have to search through that. I guess I'll have to. That one's Houndoom because its claws are constantly melting. I see.
Ugh. That sounds so bad.
Yeah. From Autumn has image. Alright, time to dig through this shit. Next page. Oh, that did not take very long. You found the Cradily image? Oh yeah, there it is. I was just about to post it, but thank you. Yeah, click on Alex's link there.
It is perfect.
I love that stupid image. Since I didn't get to post that image, I will post a different one instead. There.
Alright. Mega Glalie's jaw is permanently broken.
Oof.
Right. You know, for a temporary form that a Pokemon has, permanently
like
broken.
My jaw.
Oh yeah, I forgot that they had to, like, punch your jaw to fix it. Because you're just constantly in different states of falling apart.
Generally. It's not usually my jaw, though. That one took me by surprise.
Pinsir's just happy to be here. I don't know if I like Mega Pinsir. It's like, I like that it became useful, but it's like really over-designed. I mean, most of the Megas are. It's not as bad as fucking Sharpedo. Mega Sharpedo can fuck itself. That thing is so bad.
Yeah, I'll probably use one day, just because I can.
I like probably about half the Megas. I think they're a cool concept, and I'm sad that they're gone.
Yeah.
There needed to be more of them.
I agree.
This is Ghost.
She's called Acerola because she's ass!
Oh.
That was a really bad AVG.
Yeah, it was kind of shit.
I'm sorry. I will try again. Gacha games? More like gacha by the balls? I mean, what were they thinking?
No. Oh, did you know that this arena here predicted frickin' Centiscorch?
What?
Oh.
No, I don't know. I'm just looking at the way that the flames there look.
Oh, I see.
Sounds like Irate Gamer.
Angry, pissed off gamer, dude.
No, it was just... It's... Oh god, depending on the source, it's either angry, pissed off angry, pissed off gamer. No, pissed off angry gamer. Pissed off angry hardcore gamer. Or, what was the other one?
Fat bastard.
I actually don't remember the other one. Oh well.
Somebody find.
She is adorable.
Somebody find the spigot.
Pissed off. One-legged Puerto Rican.
I like my fucking baguette plushie. Baguette!
Now you need to get a baguette plushie.
That sounds amazing. That sounds like it would be related to the Corn Cowboy.
God damn it. My baguette plushie.
Oh,
it just appeared out of nowhere.
Should we explain the Corn Cowboy?
Sure. So I have like a neck pillow. Except I don't really use it as a neck pillow, I just kind of cuddle it in my bed. And you're supposed to put like a cover on it, but eventually I stopped bothering, and this thing is yellow.
Yeah, it's like a yellow cylinder, right?
It's a yellow cylinder, yeah. So I described this to Josh one time, he's like, oh god, it's a corn cob wife.
Well, no, because there was more to it than that. It was because when we were making the cave level in BA3, I kept singing to the music, like, corn cob wife. Sing about that wife, it's a corn cob wife, or like some stupid shit like that. And
yeah,
so,
yeah,
then that just kind of became a thing.
And,
well, you didn't get there fast enough, god damn it.
What was this question? How do you feel about the fact that you made videos around the same time as this guy?
Man, I can't believe that I live in such an age.
Yeah, seriously. Still no good Florosip and Cabin Meaties.
There was one that was sent to me, actually. I haven't tried.
Oh god, I listened to it and it's garbage. The Mew School version is fine, but it did not translate to Meaty well because it wasn't designed for Meaty. Sometimes Mew School to Meaty can work well, but this one did not. So, if you hear it, you'll absolutely agree with me.
Okay.
And the one that we have at the moment is not really good, but I think you said it kind of...
It grew on me because I've just, you know, I had to listen to it a lot, and it's like, whatever. I would still like a better one.
I said that at some point I'll look at it and try to work on it.
Vroom.
I like MM2 wood.
Ho 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 ho
ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho ho
dusts on.
It's happening.
We're doing MM2 wood. It's a legendarily bad MIDI of Woodman for Mega Man 2. It just kind of became a meme.
It's Totemire Lightning.
Yes, it is.
Oh yeah, wasn't it determined that, like, Pokemon Home can hold the totem forms from the original Sun and Moon, but not from the Ultra games? Or some stupid shit like that.
I don't know much about Pokemon Home other than Grand Oak.
I forgot about Grand Oak. Ah yes, this Pokemon that can be like four different types and is neither of the ones that it looks like.
Yeah.
I legitimately had to remember what this thing was. I'm like, steel? No. Water? No.
Sounds stupid enough to be real for Pokemon.
Come on, Ant Slam. And welcome to Japan.
I don't remember if that was, if that was real.
Let's just cuke it up.
Granddad Oak.
We'll cuke it up. I think Delmize is considered decent. It's just,
I would not be surprised if it's good. It has three stabs.
It's just fucking weird. I was annoyed at it being another grass ghost in a generation where there was a starter grass ghost after a generation that introduced two of them.
It might be one of the only Pokemon to not have any actual features to it. Like, it has no eyes, no limbs, no ears, no nose, no mouth. The Smash Warrior knows no feet. Like,
it's and dead. No? Huh.
He's floating in midair.
He has no eyes. He has no face.
Gotta hit him with the fresh ideas. What about the French ideas?
Can you, melt his icy heart with a cool island song? Or whatever the hell it was. I ask as if you know what I'm talking about. Would you rather LP Channel, Coliseum Bonus Disc, or Pokemon Box Ruby Ampersand Sapphire?
I've said this before, but do you just spend all your time trying to come up with the worst questions to ask, baby?
I mean, there's an AVGN quote. It might have been in Action 52, where he's just like, was their goal here to just make all the shitty games that they could so there would be no shitty games left to make? That's pretty much how I feel.
Oh my god.
I still can't remember what the fuck this thing's type is after even saying it out loud. Jesus Christ. Grass Ghost.
Ghost Cross.
Yeah.
I'm glad Borax got my joke. And possibly Zug if they were referring to.
I'll do a pain split in case this thing survives with 1 HP.
C/weed type. 50% C, 50% weed. 1% evil, 99% hot gas.
Hot gas.
Yeah, for some reason, both that line and the delivery on it always makes me crack up. I love the way she says 99% hot gas.
Oh god, what was the Tomodachi Life Lois voice again? It was fucking amazing.
Oh my god, I don't know. I know it was like deep and like. I can get it up right now.
I'd like some new clothes.
It's only steel in offense, like in terms of stab. It's not steel defensively.
I think I overrated the difficulty of that thing. It was not that much of an issue. Oh god, what the fuck was that updated Drifblim cry?
Cludes. Remember how in Platinum you
drop a train on him.
planned like several different teams depending on which way I chose to
evolve. Oh yeah, the mermaid.
And three out of the four possibilities involved me getting a Drifblim, because you assumed I would probably pick Wormadam because it's more interesting, but I specifically picked Mothim because it was less interesting.
Yeah.
I'm like, let's get this thing out of the way because I want to use every Pokemon eventually.
Yep, and then you ended up with a Duskull that was dead weight for like 40 levels.
Yeah, it's finally good though. The next stream of this will be me finishing Platinum, except not really.
You All right, should.
Let's listen to what Lois has to say. I'm starving. Okay, Hold on. Just said I'm starving.
Well, we gotta hear her talk more. Give it a sec.
Hang on. Yeah, I need to. I'll feed her a baked potato. I need you to say something else. Come on.
Come
Fuck.
On.
Ugh. She's leveled up, so I have to give her something.
Give her like a saying, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah.
If you can do a generic catchphrase, just have it be like Peter Iced Tea or something.
Yeah. That's. I'll do that.
Peter, I'm holding iced tea.
Let me know when you're ready. I'll turn the audio down again.
Hang on. What fucking gesture should I do? What was she like in the scene? Was she like annoyed? Like
no. I mean, she was like she was actually laughing at it because he said diarrhea, and then she just laughed for no reason.
Okay, I'll just do this. Okay, I'm ready.
That was not worth the wait.
Worth the wait.
Oh, you best hear how this is a reward. Shit. What do you have to say now?
Stopping your friends from doing bad things that's what friends are for.
It's so stupid sounding.
For the record, the reason she sounds like that is because, one, I have a European copy of the game, even with emulation, not emulation, piracy. It would not, like, the American version wouldn't work, so I had to settle for the European one. And in the European one, people sound British. Or at least in the UK one, they do. And secondly, yeah, okay. I did not spend very long trying to get the voice accurate. So
yeah, we're just like, yeah, fuck it.
Yeah, basically.
Oh, God. Okay, only one more of this. I've been taking forever getting through this shit. Flying type will do...
Your Amaze Game Freak had the brass neck. I've never heard the phrase brass neck, so I don't know
hold
what
on.
You're
I'm not done yet. Yeah, 200 Lepa Berries.
Yeah.
Frr. Yeah, what do you mean brass neck?
By the power of Tiramisu.
Poop?
What the frack, kid?
Oh God!
No!
Who the fuck is this character, and why does she have no purpose?
Why not?
It's just I don't know. It's weird.
In most Elite Fours, you don't meet the characters before fighting them. That's when they're like, "Oh, let's just do that for one of them."
I guess
she is just like she was an island challenger and then left to travel the world, and then Kukui called her and was like, "Hey, you're a good trainer. Want to be in the league?" She was like, sure. I don't know. She's fine. I like her design, too. I like that she does a Slav squat.
Yes.
My lack of knowledge of what a brass neck proves I'm not a real limey. Well, one, I resent the word limey there, and two, like I said, I'm only British when it's convenient to me. But convinced she was cut content? Maybe. There is, like, a golf course that you never get to go to, and she does appear in Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon just to teach you the fucking Flying Z move pose.
Oh, right.
Remember when the airport in Black and White was proof that you'd have Hoenn as a post-game?
Oh, yes.
Okay, bye.
Remember when the green Pokeball on the floor of the Heart Gold Soul Silver Pokemon Center proved that the next game would be an Emerald remake?
Mm, I don't remember that one, actually.
There was a channel on YouTube in
2010. Oh, it's a Mexican.
That was dedicated to making shit tons of videos pointing out anything it could as being proof that the next
was it Giancarlo Paromanga or whatever the hell?
No, it wasn't. It's some channel that's probably either faded into obscurity or just died entirely.
Oh.
I mean, I never know what to say when people are like, huh, they should have done Emerald instead, or huh, I wish they would remake Platinum instead of, like, DSP. And I'm like, I agree in principle, but I've always known that, of course, they're going to do both versions because money. I've just kind of grown to accept that, and so I kind of find it a fruitless endeavor to worry about, like, oh, they shouldn't have done that. Like, whatever, they're not going to. Just get over it. Like,
that was lame. Let's see.
No, you don't understand. This was like, Rick and this Morty. Was like looking at any details. They're like, oh, look, there is a green thing here. They mentioned
why
the
did
sky.
It turn green?
Like, yeah, exactly. Next remake should be Pokemon Gray and Pokemon Stars.
This is a good matchup.
We'll show the Pokemon Stars. I do wonder what they're gonna do with Unova though, because they can't. I highly doubt
they're
gonna
do
Black and White
2. Can I take a flying hit?
I highly doubt they're gonna do both of the games in one, like Black 2 and White 2. But I also doubt that they'll release both remakes.
I mean, they'll just do the Mario 3D All-Stars route of just, you know, ignore the sequel completely.
Oh god, you're probably right, and I hate it.
I mean, the story of Black and White 1 was better. It was just that Black and White 2 had more content.
Black and White 2 is definitely better, like, to play through.
Yeah.
Because for me,
bigger decks, more stuff to do.
Yeah, one of the biggest appeals of Pokemon is the replayability. I've not replayed any games as much as I've replayed Pokemon.
Whatever, I'll just.
Black Shirt is definitely more fun because of more options and shit. Remember when Himalaya was supposed to be Pacific Log? What do you mean by that?
What
also,
do you mean?
They'll make Black White 2 into DLC. The thing is, how? Because the content of that game is not just there's an extra thing. The content of that game is the structure is fundamentally tweaked in subtle ways throughout. Like, the beginning is different, and then there is a large section in the middle that's more or less the same, but there's events change, like, you know, random routes here and there have alterations, the story goes in a different direction, there's different fights, like, the gyms are different. How exactly would you make Black White 2 into DLC? Unless it's literally just they add in the extra areas and you can go to them as post-game, and that's it. Like, that would be kind of weird, I think. I don't know if anyone else has said this. I feel like this is kind of an... What would I say? Like, this is something people haven't really either realized or isn't, like, widely thought about, but I am convinced they were gonna make Z. Because X and Y was 2013, Oras was 2014, and then there just conspicuously wasn't a game in 2015, and then in 2016 they did Sun and Moon. I'm convinced that they were going to do Z for 2015.
I mean, I feel like...
And dropped it, and then the biggest piece of evidence for that is just the fact that there's the random Zygarde cell shit in Sun and Moon where it's...
Yeah, it was just content that they wanted to put somewhere and then didn't.
They were definitely going to put that in Z, and yeah, they definitely just moved shit from 8 to 7. The question is, why did they not make it? Did they not think they could get away with making a third version anymore?
Hmm.
I kind of doubt that, because people definitely would have still bought it. Hell, I would. It's weird. I don't know. Maybe they just felt like they didn't have enough different. But also, this is the same company that... that releases stuff that's not that
Ultra
different.
Ultra Sun Moon,
So, I don't fucking know.
It's a little weird.
Definitely weird.
Yeah, Eternal Fluet and Light of Ruin, that was definitely...
I mean, it could have been a thing where, like, they were planning to make it, but then Pokemon Company was like, we gotta get the new generation out to, like, drive up sales
but
for the anniversary.
But they skipped a year! There's no reason they couldn't have released, like...
Well, maybe because they needed the extra year to make a brand new generation, and they just... didn't have, like, they couldn't split the workforce or something. I don't know.
Okay, that makes sense, I guess. But, I mean, even still, like, this is Game Freak. They will cut corners, and they will do everything they can to do their fucking yearly releases, even at the detriment of the game, like with fucking Sword and Shield, where it came out half-baked because they didn't have enough time to finish it.
Oh no, not Flatter.
I mean, I don't even know if I'm upset that they didn't make Z, because it probably would have not been that different from X and Y, and people would have complained about it being a usual third version.
Yeah, kind of.
But at the same time, I am curious.
Saw that former short coming.
Did AZ ever get a wrap-up for a story? Yeah. He shows up in the ending, and he's like... Well, Well, first you fucking free him from jail, and he's like, "Thank you for releasing me." And then after after you beat the champion, he shows up and challenges you to a battle just for fun, I guess. And then Floette comes back and forgives him, and he cries, and it's actually a pretty decent moment.
Yeah. Yeah, X and Y kind of tried to have a story in, like, the last quarter of the game, I feel.
I have a soft spot for X and Y. I feel like there's a soul to that game that Sword and Shield are kind of missing. And I know that's kind of a buzzword, you know, people on 4chan always talk about, oh, this game is soulless and this game has soul. Yeah. But I do kind of get what they mean. X and Y felt like it really... It's charming. It feels pretty consistent, aside from the weird pacing between Gens 1 and 2. I don't know, I kind of like X and Y, even if there's some
problems with it.
I put it in, like, the mid-tier of Pokemon games, but I always look forward to replaying it. I've played it, like, 4 times now.
I wouldn't mind doing an eventual playthrough of that for YouTube or Twitch.
Yeah. I mean, I'm probably gonna bug you once you're done with Crystal. Eventually, I'll probably be like, you should do Gen 5. And then, you should do Black 2 White 2. Next time I play them, I'm probably gonna do Y though, because now that I actually have access to,
the power of piracy.
Yes, now that I have access to piracy, I figure I may as well mix it up and play the other game. X is the first slash only Pokemon game you got bored with and put down for a while.
Okay, does Mandibuzz just have insane defense?
Yeah, it's very defensive. I don't know if it's insane, but it's very good. What is the point of Flatter?
It's 100% accuracy confusion move. It's
It's
a shittier version of Swagger that you can use on things that are
like... it's a side grade. Because Swagger is, they damage themselves for more at the cost of the fact that when they come out of confusion, if they're a physical attacker, they'll be stronger. That's always what I took it as. Whereas Flatter is like, if you don't want to deal with the risk associated with that.
Goodbye.
Then it's 100% accurate confuse move for things that don't have confuse rank. Unfinished run of Y from 2014. Get on my level. I've played the game 4 times since it released.
Was not expecting Oricorio. Okay. I'm glad I set up the Stealth Rock.
Nice.
Yeah, was not expecting Oricorio as the last Pokemon here.
I like the Berserk gene. Are you still vaporized, Nicole?
Usually.
Well, we can't say fried, so...
Yes, that's offensive for some reason.
Okay, so
is a puddle of mush.
Miserable little pile of mush.
So I'm assuming I still fight Kukui here. I don't remember if they changed it. You don't have to confirm it.
Well, if you don't remember, then I will not confirm or deny. And I would prefer if the chat does not confirm or deny.
They'll be like, actually, you fight Lorelei.
Prima.
Yes.
Oh no. I need to go right away.
See you then.
Yeah, it wasn't too much left. I will.
Well, I don't have to go like right now, but like, I have gotten the supper's soon text.
Okay.
So.
You fight yourself. Hi, I'm Actual Strong Bad.
It's funny because he said holy crap.
I forgot Strombad was here.
The robot ain't got no arms.
Fight all the QR codes I scanned. Oh yeah, all of those. I did scan a lot of them in Moon, but yeah, in this I don't think I ever did.
You did one.
Oh, okay.
That's what I said earlier.
One.
You could actually figure out something.
What?
No, I'm just gonna stop there. I'll continue in a minute.
Okay. Could figure out something.
Hey, listen up, Haley. Here, I give you advice you didn't ask for.
He's still going down there.
Yeah.
And fight the champion. Whoever that is.
Nope, we're the champion. Well, we're going to be.
Well, it's either going to be him or Hao. Okay, yeah, it's him. No? Oh, shit, they did change it up. Cool.
What I was going to say is, you in the original, you fought Hao right before, like, after the Pokemon Center, but before entering the league, and they removed that fight. If you had noticed that, you might have been able to figure out that it was maybe Hao.
I had a feeling it might be. I didn't know one way or the other, though.
So what do you mean musical blue balling? What's wrong with the champion?
What's wrong with Hao?
With the league final battle or whatever it's called. The real champion battle should have been against your mum.
That would be kind of like a neat twist. If, like, your mom used to be, like, a Pokemon trainer, and then you get to the very end and she has been recruited as champion, and you're like, mother?
Yeah, that'd be interesting to have the mom actually have a role. I know that she's, like, somebody who does contests in Gen 4, but that's about it.
In Gen 6, she was a ride-on racer.
Oh, yes.
Or ride-on racer.
Oh, yeah.
In my, concept for a Pokemon game that I got partway through telling you about, except I told you about the concept, I just never finished going over all the designs with you, Josh. In that one, the story involved the player's mother having been a former champion, I think.
Well, this is looking like a, full restore right here. Yeah. Oh, the Randy Marsh bouncing on his balls music, okay.
Yep. Your mom is the professor of the region, but your dad is a stay-at-home dad.
Really,
I do wish the dad would show up, but I find it very weird. The game's just like, no.
I mean, he is in one of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jeff Gray.
That's it.
Nothing else.
God.
I don't have any ice moves on my team, do I?
I didn't have the mother be the professor in mind, but I did have the professor be the villainous team leader.
Oh, that's... okay. Shit. I knew I want... okay. Before the battle, I used a Lepaberry on Thousand Arrows. I meant to actually use it on Stone Edge.
Oh dear.
Oops.
Well, I will take the turn to set up a Stealth Rock, if I don't die.
You won't.
Okay.
Take it down!
Get prone.
You're very lucky.
False. And hopefully don't die to a flying move. Do you just know the stats well enough that you can make that call, or are you just guessing?
It's a gut feeling. I've played enough Pokemon that I had... That was what I was... If you asked me, what do you think will happen, that would be my answer, basically. But it was not like I'm like, oh yes, I have calculated it in my head. It was just a sense of it.
Oh, come the fuck on.
Sucks, I'm sorry. At least you can take another hit. We'll do that. Oh yeah, I've been assuming that, let's see, we're at 896, is that right?
898.
Really? Oh, yeah, 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 you're right.
Wait, is it? Yeah, it is.
I gotta check.
It was $8.90 before the DLC.
That's right, they added 5 in Crown Tundra, okay. Was there, for some reason, I thought it was 3 and 3, but it's 3 and 5. Okay, yeah, $8.98. So, assuming the next gen has, like, 80 Pokemon, that'll bring us up to slightly less than 1,000. So, I don't know, I feel like it would kind of make sense for Gen 10 to hit 1,000, so maybe they'll stop at 999 in Gen 9, and then start with 1,000 and have it be like a big teeny situation where the first Pokemon is some kind of special mythical, and then do the...
Maybe.
And have like 1,001 be the starters or something. But they also might just not care.
Yeah, they have a tendency to not really give a shit about the numbers they end on, aside from Gen 2.
In the hundreds, like, 800 was a special Pokemon, and I think... No, I think that was actually it. They did make sure to have a... Oh yeah, that's true. We hit a new 100 each gen except for this one. They probably won't add two more than I agree. Oh, actually no. I kind of feel like... it depends, because we've only had one mythical so far this gen, so I actually think they probably will have two more.
Okay, I do have to go now.
Okay. Yeah, we'll figure out what we're doing next week, I guess, and I will message you later.
See y'all.
Have a good night.
Bye, Leslie. I don't feel like 386, 493, and 649 are significant numbers. Only in the sense that Pokemon made them so.
Yeah.
But before that, I would not have thought so.
Shit, are you gonna full restore again?
You could, like, the only ones I could see is maybe 151, 251, 649, 721.
I have a feeling he's gonna full restore again.
Because those are one off from, like, multiples of 10.
Do I have max revives?
I guess 809 is too, but that's kind of an awkward one. It's not that crazy. The series has been going for a long time.
But it's still a new series, and I can't believe that they would put that in the Nintendo crossover.
The game did stop releasing in America after 1997, which does make them new.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Shiny Christmas Pikachu winking with a bent ear.
I don't think a particular computer model having 386 in the name makes it a significant number,
to be honest. It's not at all.
I think of significant numbers in terms of, like, interesting properties, I guess. But even then, there's probably a lot of weird numbers. So I'm also just, like, lots of factors and stuff.
I feel like the original variants, in most cases, pretty much just are different Pokemon. But, I mean, then you get stuff like Diglett. So it's...
Yeah.
It kind of depends.
I count them as new designs.
Like, there's some where it's just like, why the fuck is Sandshrew even called Sandshrew when it's not a ground type anymore? It's like, yeah. This thing should just be Snowshrew or something. Like...
Mm-hmm.
If fucking male versus female Nidoran can be different Pokemon, I think this can be.
Well, that's just early installment weirdness. You know, that wouldn't have been the case if they made it later.
Right.
They're like, we don't have gender in Pokemon, so let's make it, so let's base, like, a split between two different things on, you know, a fake gender that we build into the Pokemon name, basically. Uh-oh, I said fake gender. I'm gonna get canceled.
Oh, no. So earlier I asked, why do people hate Magnezone? Why do people hate Crabominable? I actually think this thing is kind of interesting.
I think because people find it ugly, probably. But I like it.
Oh, shit. Okay. That could have gone better.
I've seen people dislike Crabominable. Honestly, I do think it's kind of ugly, but I don't really hold that against it. There are animals that are ugly. It's fine that it looks a little bit weird. I still think it's a cool Pokemon.
Okay, let's see how much of a hit I take.
TV of the DP remakes. Probably because it's not different enough. Like, it doesn't look that different from just playing the base game visually. Why do people like get the fuck out of here right now?
Phalanx is best boy.
Phalanx is the best fucking Pokemon introduced in Gen 8.
I can't explain why. I mean, I just like it because it's a weird concept.
It's fucking amazing. I love it. Like, it's not, yeah, again, the concept is not that different from, like, Execute or something, but it's just six little guys. That's fucking amazing. I love them. They're just little army boys. I love them.
I wouldn't get that passionate about Phalanx, but I do, it is my favorite of the gen.
It's my favorite.
I think it's
just
a fucking weird design, and I kind of love it.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Let's see.
Gen 8 is a really solid gen in terms of designs. I at least think so, and I don't know if this is like still the case, but as far as I remember, 4chan really likes Gen 8's designs. And the only reason I mention that is because like I tend to lurk
there
around
there. That's innards out.
Yeah. Nice. I tend to it's based on the Phalanx formation. It's basically a bunch of little army guys that have shields to the Phalanx is a formation where you can basically surround all sides of the group in shields to protect them from arrows and stuff, and they can all kind of move as a unit to just kind of be this big armored group.
Oh, fucking full restore, I knew it.
Phalanx is the worst Pokemon of Gen 7 because
oh,
it's
ghost
not
type.
Gen 7
I'm
Pokemon.
Smart.
Oh. What do you mean decayed popcorn kernel? What the fuck are you talking about? It's how? In what way? They're just like little black spheres, little black squash balls, with fucking. What do you mean crystallized? Just because they have red things on it, you can't call it crystallized ketchup blotches to make it sound worse than it is. It clearly looks like armor and helmets. Yeah, proof that hating Phalanx destroys your brain. I completely agree with you, baby. But yeah, anyway,
okay, so basically,
oh, fuck, can't believe you've done this. I hang around 4chan during leak season. I was there for Gen 7 leaks, I was there for Gen 8 leaks, I'll probably be there again for Gen 9 leaks.
Oh shit, I forgot about Honkadoodle.
I love Honkadoodle, and Honkadoo.
You cock!
Anyway, as each new design was being leaked, almost all of them were received extremely well, with people being like, oh my god, this is a super good design. Because there's always the detractors, but I was so used to 4chan being negative about anything that would be revealed about Pokemon especially, and video games in general, that it was actually really weirdly refreshing to see every new design be met with like, holy shit, this is so cool! It was endearing. I don't know if opinions have changed over the past, like, year and a half, but...
Oh my fucking god.
Stone Journal's weird. I don't dislike it, but I don't... It's not one of my favorites.
Stone Journal? Oh, I didn't even see the comment on that one. That was from Balls, I guess.
Hey, hello. Finish what you started. Are you talking about how you gave this 3DS to Josh so he could do this stream? And now he's finally finishing the game?
It only took 6 years.
I mean, yeah, I'm sure that a lot of people, probably even on the board, would call it a containment board. Because holy shit, can Pokemon fans be terrible. Both on 4chan and otherwise. I kind of hate the PWT, by the way.
You kind of hate what?
The PWT and all of the battle facilities. They're just not designed for people who aren't, like, building a
team. I like the World Tournament, but I don't like any of the other battle facilities. That one I thought
it's really
was...
Not,
just...
It's not really any different for me.
Eh. I guess it's because all the competitors are known entities, and it's like...
Okay, yeah, I agree with you that it's probably better than them in terms of, like, being more interesting, in terms of what you do and the people you fight and all that kind of thing. I do like that the idea of, like, oh, you bring everyone from around the world. But they didn't make it any better. Like, it still sucks and is annoying to do, unless you build a team from scratch, so... it's not that different. It's still just battles against stuff.
Yeah.
But this time it's like
Tauros.
Existing characters. Yeah, he has a Tauros because like Hala had a pet Tauros. Remember on the first island?
Sort of. I'm gonna be spamming the shit out of these max revives, and I don't care.
PWT is the only facility that you can beat with in-game team and doesn't waste your fucking time. Now, see, here's the thing, you're wrong. Because I tried to do it on several different teams, and it's extremely unreliable. Like, I can have a good, like, a deal, I good, you know. For an in-game team, like, you know, pick good moves and stuff, good items, and it doesn't really help. Like, it's still way harder than anything else in the game, and...
God.
Right? Yeah.
Alright, cool.
I'm not sure what you mean about not wasting your fucking time, though, just because it doesn't take as long to get to the bosses, because that I will agree with you on.
Oh, yeah, like, that's the thing I fucking hate, is like, oh, you gotta get a streak of 100 battles to fight the one that you came for. It's like,
yeah,
I fucking hate
that. I agree with that.
Okay, he's down to his last one. I probably need to revive more stuff.
I would agree with that. I'm assuming this Vaporeon probably has Ice Beam, so...
Yeah.
Both two cannon and Vignette are gonna have a rough time.
Well, let me gotta use Toxic. Actually, I don't even need to use a full revive on that. It's...
Well, I mean, ultimately, you know that the Battle Frontier like cheats, right? And it gives them better odds than you. Yeah, I feel the same way, Pokemasterian. I don't understand why so many people are like, give us back the Battle Frontier, even though, yeah, they fucking suck.
I guess it's just to have something to do in-game if you like the competitive battling stuff. Like, it's not without its merits, it's just I find it really annoying to set up for and really disheartening when you put together a good team and, like, put in hours and then it's just like, oh, hey, this thing killed you with Fisher, sorry. It's like, okay. Yeah.
Fishing in a reservoir area. I thought I told you to go away for disliking Phalanx. Why are you still here? Yeah, okay, I can agree with you, Dr. Bill. You convinced me that there is a significant step up from most Battle Frontiers to PWT. I still don't like PWT, though. It's still too... It's too tightly tuned, and I feel like you need to specifically build a team for it, even still. Because like I said, I've tried to do in-game team stuff in that, and I struggled a lot with it. I could rarely beat it. I would say maybe a quarter of the time I would actually beat
it. I guess
it.
I can say this much. When I did it, like, I didn't go through everything in it, but I mean, I did it for a decent amount of time, and, like, I did actually have, like, EV-trained, like, good stuff for that. And the reason I did was because I thought the area was cool enough to warrant me putting in the effort to do that, whereas none of the other facilities did. So that's where it kind of wins for me.
Hmm. Well, okay, well, here's the thing, Dr. Babel. Like, at the end of the day, it's just our experiences. With you, you were able to do it, and I'm telling you that I tried really hard, and I could not consistently win against it, and it felt too hard for what it was. So it's just kind of an experiential, like, anecdotal thing, and I don't even think we're really disagreeing here. I'm just saying, in my experience, I found it too hard, and in your experience, you didn't. Like, maybe it's the teams we used. Maybe it's...
Maybe it's the way you're dressed.
Maybe it's the way you're dressed. Oh, heavens no, the punch gloves are plentiful.
40
Benadryls!
Okay, using Toxic in case he full restores. Yep.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we're just gonna stall out this fight here, fuck this. It's a little lame, but I mean, Kuke's gotta get the...
Kuke is based on Soul.
Yeah, Kuke's gotta get the win.
It's required.
So let's recover for fucking like 10 turns, however long this takes. I like how it's just resorted to using attack down on me.
I can't see or hear the phrase baby doll without thinking of the trap series.
Oh god.
Last I checked, it was you and me, baby doll.
Worst.
I have Diala from that in Tomodachi Life as well, by the way.
I want Diala to be friends with Diala.
I should probably put Dan McNeely in as well, honestly.
Yeah.
He is iconically bad enough. Part of the reason I went with Diala is just to have a female character, but yeah, Dan McNeely needs to be included. Oh, I love the Battle Frontier quotes. Like, I swallow sludge to transform myself, which I see more people sharing than... There you go, there's I swallow sludge.
Yeah.
Like, I have always interpreted that as, oh, it's funny because it sounds like taking HRT to transition. And other people are just like, oh, haha, eating sludge. Which is fine, I mean, you know, that's
fuck!
I always thought that people found it funny because of the first
one. Oh, this is annoying.
There's also, speaking of, like, things that could be interpreted that way, there's also, well... First thing was more of an interpretation, this one's more outright, but there's the, like, the trans woman in the, battle maison, I think?
Right.
The beauty that's like, I used to be a black belt. Quite the transformation, wouldn't you say? And in the Japanese version, she said, like, it's all thanks to modern medicine.
Do I actually have any Pokemon here that isn't weak to either water or ice other than Kyuke? Because I would try to switch in to, like, make this less painful.
No, but, it's just Kyuke.
I mean, I can still brown.
Pieces of brown.
So yeah, this is just spam recover the battle. This is stupid.
It actually does not have Ice Beam.
Oh. I know, I'm so sorry. I'm legitimately feel bad that I haven't done that. I went through half of it and then stopped. It's a process that would have taken me like 10 minutes, and I still couldn't bring myself to do it.
Do you wanna do it like while we're on a call sometime?
Maybe.
At some point.
Okay, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna pain split this turn to actually give it more HP to get the toxic timer higher so that he doesn't heal it, maybe. He's still probably gonna heal. Yeah, oh, now it's in the red. Shit. Well, let's see. Does he have another full restore? No. Okay, it's dead.
Dang, I haven't really been pressuring him, honestly.
I've been wanting to do it for months. I just can't bring myself to actually take the time to do it. That was a stupid final battle.
That's okay. So, I have you decided what you're doing next week with this?
No, because,
Well, not next week, sorry.
I mean, it could be next week, just probably not Monday.
Right. Next time, in general.
Yeah. I mean, I want to see post-game of this. I do eventually want to do post-game of S.H.I.E.L.D., probably. It might not be on stream, though. That's not really determined. Nicole needs to finish White and would potentially be interested in doing that.
The big question is,
Who is the question?
About whether or not you're gonna actually end up doing Crystal on stream.
Yeah. God, I probably should.
I think you should as well. I think you should still do the bios, but have it just be like a separate video at the end or something.
That's fair. Oh god, we get 30 minutes of cutscenes, I forgot about that.
Yeah. Were you involved in the equation with streaming Isaac? I mean, I wouldn't mind, and it's up to Josh, but...
I guess.
I did want to have you stream Isaac, though, at some point. I mean, there's lots of stuff we want to stream.
Yeah.
Like, we're not done with 3D World, we just haven't had a good time to do that. And right. The internet fucking up the last time we tried kind of put a damper on things. No, I'm pretty sure the credits are still really long in this. Well, the ending, I should say. And, yeah, you know, there's, like, Mega Man 11 eventually. There's, the TP Rando, which you've talked about.
Right.
There was other stuff.
But is there actually?
Yeah.
Okay. P is stored in the balls as a real unreleased demo by Daft Punk.
Okay. Didn't they get divorced recently? Yes, I'm gonna call it that. No, I mean, Daft Punk just split up and... No, I mean, no, I think they retired. Like, it's not like, oh, they had creative differences. I think they're just like, we're done. That place didn't exist in 2001.
I mean, there were several things wrong with that statement.
Yeah, I know. There's no right or wrong with the PWG.
I mean, I could bust out my copy of White 2 and see how much of it I've completed. I don't know what I'd be proving. Like,
there's nothing to prove. You happen to have such a team and luck that it was not really challenging, and my team and my luck was such that it was challenging and inconsistent to beat stuff. Fun fact, Josh wasn't even alive in May of 2001.
If only.
I mean, that's just an oxymoron right there. Like, you can't just say, oh, it's a fact, but it's not a correct one. Like, by definition, a fact is correct.
Ha 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 ha. Doing what? What am I doing as well?
Crystal clear, apparently. No, you're not.
I don't know what that is. I mean, there's so many Pokemon ROM hacks that are like, oh man, this is like the best one ever made. You should try this. It's like, I wanted to try Prism. I just didn't play. I didn't do it because I think it came out right around the time I started Crystal, and I'm like, nah, I don't want to do a hack of the game I'm already doing.
When the hell did you borrow us to do Crystal Clear with Red Star? I don't remember that.
Was that a thing?
He's saying in chat that you're doing Crystal Clear with him at some point.
I don't remember this. It's very possible that I might have actually agreed to that and then just forgot. That sounds like something I'd do. What is like a one-time thing? Because I definitely wouldn't do a full playthrough of it.
Oh.
See, I don't remember this, but I will take your word for it.
I mean, you don't need to take his word for it. If he's a patron, then he can make whatever request. Then you can accept up an island. Pokemon ranch dressing. Never tried ranch, but it has mayonnaise in it, so I don't think I'd like it.
Wait, you've never had ranch dressing?
Yeah, it's not really much of a thing, yeah.
Oh, huh. It's like, for me at least, I think it's like the go-to thing for salad. Like, and people also use it as a dipping sauce for a lot of stuff.
I don't think I've really explicitly ordered a salad anywhere at like a restaurant. I've only ever had it either as like a side that happens to come with it, or I do make salads for a lot of my meals, but for those, I get lettuce, tomatoes, spring onions, rocket, which you guys call arugula.
Wait, why are we looking at Zygarde in a cave? What the hell? Okay.
And garlic, and I dress it with... Oh, sorry, and I grate some cheese in there as well. And I dress it with balsamic vinegar, malt vinegar, and then I put salt, pepper, cayenne, oregano, dried parsley. That's pretty much it. I don't know what kind of salad you call that. It's just my custom like things
I
like.
I mean, okay. Mine is nowhere near that fancy. I don't make salads. There's a Cobb salad I get from Chick-fil-A a lot, and other than that, it's just like, yeah, if it's a side that comes with something, then I'll eat it. But yeah, I always go with ranch dressing. I would say here it's like, I mean, it depends on the person, of course, like everyone's going to be a little different, but people seem to really like just having ranch as a dipping sauce. Like, it's a, you can order it as, like, you can order a cup of it with your pizza, and people will get that, dip the pizza in it.
I mean, I dip pizza in ketchup and barbecue sauce.
That's weird. I don't dip it in ranch either, to be fair. I think that that's
I mean,
weird
that's
too.
That's normal. Having ketchup with pizza or barbecue sauce in the UK is normal.
Huh. I have definitely never heard of ketchup. Barbecue sauce, sort of.
I mean, I told you this before, and you did find it weird before, but I would think you would remember.
You overestimate my ability to remember things.
That's true. And to be fair, I was in chat at the time.
Quick, stump really Petunie.
Autumn, why would you do that? It's just a thing over here, okay? There's nothing wrong with it. It tastes fine. Like, I'm not gonna smother it.
Nothing wrong with maple syrup on Oreos.
Maple syrup on Oreos sounds fine. They're both sweet.
How would you know? You've never had maple syrup.
Pizza's too much flavor. It doesn't need a sauce. I don't know. I find pizza kind of dry unless I have a bit of ketchup with it. The barbecue. Well, usually I have both.
868. Fuck, it's Gen 8.
Well, stump it to me.
Yeah, okay. Let's see. 830 is Greedent. 840 is Applin. 50 is Sizzlipede. Sizzlipede. 60 is...
You can come back.
Morgrim, I think. So then it's Grimmsnarl, the six evolutions, then I think Milsuri, 868. Oh, wait, did you... You were very quiet. I heard a sound that might have either been you saying hi, or it could have just been like a mouse a few countries away.
Both.
Okay.
Do you guys replay Gen 6 often? I have played Gen 6 four times, and I have pretty well enjoyed it every time. I would still put it in the middle of the Pokemon games. It's not amazing. Like, let me get my fucking tier list.
I like how you have a tier list. I will just answer. I played Y at release. I thought it was pretty good. I did, like, full living decks in it and everything. Liked the team that I had in that. It was fun. I played through X as, like, I did that one later on, like, a few years later, because Martin had that, he had that version and just never got past, like, the second gym because he just found the game boring. And then I gave him, like, a custom team to, like, start a new file with. He got to the same part and was just like, I can't, this is too boring. And so I ended up just kind of taking the game, and I did a playthrough with six shitty Pokemon. I kind of had fun with that.
Did you stream the ending of that? Actually, no, you didn't stream it, you just uploaded it to YouTube.
And then Omega Ruby, I mostly played, I feel like I played the majority of that game in bathroom breaks at work, but I don't think that's actually true. I mean, I just found that game really bland. I don't know. It's weird, because I like Gen 3. I thought the remakes were kind of... Eh.
I like Oras quite a bit.
I really like the remakes, but to be fair, I'd never played the originals.
I can't even say that they're worse than the originals, because they are probably better games. I just, for some reason, didn't have much interest in it.
Fair.
I think it was probably just because at that point I was already, like, kind of fresh out of a couple other Pokemon playthroughs, and I was just sort of going through the motions.
Yeah, understandable. I definitely have been burned out on Pokemon several times. I'm kind of still burnt out on it right now. Let me post my,
How are there still credits?
Because it's this game. I'll post the tier list in our chat, and then I'll post the link to it in the Twitch chat. There you go.
Okay, you know what? Let's turn off 3DS top. Don't need it.
What is
and,
this?
Tier
list.
I'm gonna I just wanted to show off this full image because it's fucking gigantic and pretty cool.
Yeah, this image is cool.
So we've seen all the Gen 7 stuff. Let me just kind of. I don't know who made this, and therefore I'm a horrible person because I'm sharing art without giving them credit.
Let's not get into that can of worms. I mean, no, FRLG isn't exactly the place I meant to put it.
I'm just gonna scroll through it.
There's so much going on.
Yeah. Weird spoopy thing in the top right. Oh, at the very top of the image. I think it might
That's the Ghost Ring Gem one.
Yeah. Oh, also the Hoodoo is still poking in. Good.
Is this the drawing of every Pokemon?
It's every Pokemon and every form of them, including, like, Smash Bros. Recolors, like, weird side series stuff. But
is this the one that we were pointing out that there's weird art inconsistency and some of it seems stolen and shit like that?
I think actually most of it seems like they I don't know, it's either traced or, like, directly copied the models from, like, the Gen 6 or, like, 7
there's
or 8.
There's a bunch of Gen 1 things that are, like, based on the original Gen 1 sprites, right?
Oh, yeah, like, here, towards the bottom left now, you've got, like, the weird red-blue Cloyster, upside-down coughing, black Jinx, that kind of stuff. But yeah, there's cool stuff in here, though. It's got the gender differences for everything that has them. So let's see, we go back up to the top. Is that Gen 1 Ghost?
I can't see it. On stream.
Maybe that's the Let's Go Ghost.
I think so, yeah.
Got all the Megas in here. There's just a triangle. I like that one. I've got all the PokéStar Studios things.
It's like a triangle.
What's that weird blue crystal thing towards the bottom left? Is that from one of the movies, maybe?
Hang on.
There's also, like, a weird black mesh. I don't know what that stuff is.
I don't know which crystal you're referring to. This thing might be too far behind.
It's below Yveltal.
Oh! That's the Bitacle from, Mystery Dungeon Gates to Infinity. And I think it has Dark Matter next to it, which is the villain from Super Mystery Dungeon.
I like how next to between the two Xerneases, there's just the weird, like, the fly bird. Also, I guess that's Primal Dialga. Teaser of your shitty spreading work. Oh god. I mean, it looks pretty much like the Victip's Adventure sprite. It looks good.
I'm not sure about the, like...
It is kind of wobbling when it moves upwards, yeah.
The stretching upwards, but I totally understand because as it is in the Victip's Adventure games, he just doesn't animate when walking upwards.
Right.
So...
I like Dekamark. I'm glad that one's in there.
What's Dekamark?
The missing Pokedex image for Gen 3. That's just like the question mark thing.
Alright.
There's like a weird Darkrai thing going on above all the different Arceus forms. I don't know what that one is.
Oh, that's Phantasmal Darkrai from,
Merry Christmas!
Was it, like, Pokemon the Calamity or something? No, I just made that up.
I'm like, what the fuck is that?
Calamity Pokemon?
Yeah.
Breath of the Wild 2?
No, it's a sequel to Breath of the Wild.
Ah, yes.
Breath of the Wild 3 2.
I think they will probably finally show more of that at E3 this year.
If not E3, then maybe the end of the year.
Mm-hmm.
These credits are still fucking going, like, oh my god.
Phantasmal Darkrai sounds like an edgy, shitty fan thing. I mean, yeah.
Wailord takes up an offensively large amount of space. I mean, yeah. But not as much as, frickin' Totem Wishy-Washy here. Also, nobody asked... Nobody asked about the weird yellow thing in the top left. I know what it is. I wasn't sure if other people did.
It's obvious. I feel like.
Hmm?
I feel like it's obvious.
I mean, when I saw this posted on Reddit, a lot of people didn't know what it was. But yeah, it's the thing from the Tapu Z-move. All right. Are we done here? What are we doing?
What do you mean, I just wish they would finish the fight to pass 2? You think they're gonna not? It's been slow because of, like, lockdown. What do you expect?
I expect 4 bonus characters for free, and all of them are my dead girlfriend.
Oh boy.
Why is this in French? What? The fuck? Okay. That was weird.
Well, because what if you're French?
Okay, but it didn't do any other languages.
That's not even... That doesn't even strike me as weird.
Well, yeah, because it's normal for you there. Like, if anything, it would be, like, in Spanish. Nah, it's not Comic Sans.
Fuck Quebec.
It's, like, it's Benjamin font.
Oh, is it?
I actually really would like to play Victor's Adventure 2 on the 3DS, and I probably could if I, like, got the right custom firmware and tried to... Is there a version of Zelda Classic on Linux? I can't remember.
I don't know. I don't know.
There might be a way to do that.
Let's see. The things I have not picked up. Palkia, Yveltal, Thundurus, Kyogre, Shiny Poipole, Zerlera, and Lugia. I missed a few of the events, I think.
If you guys want to get some fucking, like, what would you call it? Just, like, harsher in hindsight? Not really, but just, like, funny aneurysm moment or something, I guess.
Funny, huh?
If you go to the Mega Man 3 stream VOD and look at, like, I don't remember when it was, but at some point in the chat, this was the first stream I had ever watched of yours live. In the chat at one point, I asked you if you had, like, what your thoughts on Mighty No. 9 were. I'm like, oh, it's like this game being made by Keiji Inafune, Mega Man creator and all that. You know, like, I haven't heard of that, or like people with gaming news. But at that time, it wasn't really evident that the game would be got dumpster fire. So it's funny now.
Gotta do it. Haven't played this game in years.
No, you can't. I forbid you.
Oh dear.
Oh, this camera.
You better not get sucked back into this.
I'm not gonna get sucked back into it. God, this camera quality.
And not get sucked into Facebook either.
Oof, I can't even see. I don't think we can actually play this.
Good.
Yeah, fuck it.
Oh no.
Oh no, what are we gonna do?
That was a false alarm.
Yeah, a little bit. We will, however, do Rumble. No, we won't. Okay.
Okay, right now.
Yeah, I guess we're kind of ending here. I don't have there's no point in doing any post-game stuff, because I'm not going to do it for long if I did. And,
you don't want to go through more wormholes?
Bitches, I'm talking host stuff. What do you mean by post-game has been canceled?
Alright.
God.
He's not going to play Shuffle 2, even if it gets enough.
Gifts. Oh boy, Planet Robobot demo. Tomodachi Life demo. I have both of these games. We'll play Sun 1. Not to be confused with Sung 1. System Junk.
Sung
Games and
you
such.
Have, like, an English name?
Clearly go play Me Plaza.
I mean, I could, but yeah. I'm not gonna do White 2. I did entertain the idea of just kind of going through a whole bunch of old Pokemon games in one stream, but I don't think it would be entertaining for longer than, like, maybe 20 minutes. Just be like, hey, look, here's my living decks in here. Like, so, I don't know, maybe. I think we should probably just be done. I still have not eaten anything today other than ice cream and a candy bar.
You should definitely eat.
Eat, Garfield, eat.
Eat.
Stuff in your face as usual.
God.
So, let's see, I'll just type a racist slur in the chat. And we're done.
Oh, good.
Hooray.